Just get ready for work, 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 work. To me, I be work, 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 work. You see me do me da 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 da. There's something about that work, 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 work. Da 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 da. When you walk out, da 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 da. Before the table, da 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 da. Beg you something, please, baby, don't you leave. Don't leave me stuck here in the street.
Slow the motion. Don't get out of the way to no one. Long distance, I need you. When I see potential, I just gotta see you. Time and a place, you'll spend some time away. Now you need to forward and give me all
work, 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 work. You send me out there, work, 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 work. You see me do my da 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 da. Something about that work, 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 work. When you walk out, la 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 la. When the cat from my da 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 da.
Yeah, we in here.
Baby, I got.
Number 14, Sophie Terabolsi. 15, Lauren Scherf. And number 23, Sarah Slater. The head coach. Your team manager is Tracy Charles. We now ask the and the players, coaches, and officials in being upstanding for the Australian
got a spare one? Do you need it? We can share? That's all right. I'm not going anywhere. What's that one? Yep. Game ball? I didn't have a clue, mate. Check 1-2. And we got...
Hello. Hello, hello. Hello.
Nope. Nothing.
Nope. No, I can't hear anything.
There we... Oh.
We're almost ready for tip-off here. It's the Anzac Day special, the annual clash between Frankston and Dandenong. We are underway. Lauren Scherf gets the...
Another foul on Lauren.
It's, well, it's away from the basket. Oh, what a pass inside. And Scherf...
Both players going at each other. Pass by Claire Papps. Veteran of the Rangers. Chasing her for a... To attend college.
Court to catch them better before.
No, absolutely. Time as well.
Decent, hasn't she?
They really look on song on offense. 17 early points.
Fiamenko with some good defense up the floor on Wattman. Here's Clydesdale. She's looked aggressive the last couple of minutes. And she draws a foul on Bowen. And she's tough once she gets into the paint.
Yeah, probably a couple of defensive breakdowns there. Fiamingo let her have the open lane to the basket. And no one was on that split line ready to give early help. And by the time Bowen got across, she was already up on the ring, giving away the M1. So can't afford to have those breakdowns against the Rangers.
Second foul there on Kelly Bowen. So it was... Only a minute or so ago, we were saying she didn't have any fouls, but you know the aggression of Amy Clydesdale is just starting to break down that Frankston defense. A little bit of zone here from the Rangers. 2:10 to go until quarter time. Phillips, this time off to Fiamenko. Nice fake. And Chatfield from the pocket can't get it to go. Bowen inside, and that's the danger with the zone defense.
Yep. Be interesting to see what Mike Brookins does here. Is he going to take Bowen out? And get, or is he going to roll the dice and keep her with two?
We saw him roll the dice a couple of weeks ago with Kayla Standish on two, and she got that third on a little rebounding foul. Here's Chatfield. She missed her last one. The Blues are a different team when she's making that mid-range shot.
No, she is. Look, down on a little bit of form since round one, but they'll be looking for her to bounce back tonight.
17-13. The Blues lead this one. Here's
offensive
Clydesdale again.
Ooh.
Steve might Blackley
have been,
wanted
might have been
an offensive foul
on that one. Potentially with a little arm bar and pushed off, but got away with that.
That's the fourth team foul on the Blues. Just over 100 seconds until quarter time. Nice inbound. Scherf inside, turns,
just
faces,
too easy.
Hits. Carly Chatfield looking to be aggressive, fronting the post, but she didn't have any help in behind her.
Now she's got to be smart, knowing there was no one back there. And
here's Phillips going that pick and roll. We've seen a little bit more of this already this week than we had earlier in the season. Shot clock at six. Tough pull up from Tenaya. She's off the mark. Bowen inside.
Bowen close to getting that third foul.
Again, we see Coach Brookins happy to leave Kelly Bowen out there. And of course, with Emma Nankervis out injured, it does limit his big rotation.
Yep, Emma hopefully she'll be out for next weekend against Tassie, but she'll be back the following week. So she's not too far away, which will be great.
Here's Clydesdale. She's been a handful the last couple of minutes. This time she teams up with Papavs. Excellent execution from Dandenong.
Yeah, defensive breakdown again. The breakdowns have been costly for the Blues.
Phillips spins to the left, finds Chatfield, and again, Carly can't get that one to go. It's 17 apiece.
Another shot she needs to make. Beautiful pass by Phillips.
Oh, tough pull-up jump shot there from Bree Watman. And after the Blues had just snuck away, all of a sudden, Dandenong in front as we close in on quarter time. Fiamenko from long range. She didn't hesitate. Jeff's inside. Bowen inside.
Good hustle by Fiamenko, keeping that one alive as Bowen blows the layup.
So not only a couple of seconds between game and shot clock here, Dandenong with a chance to extend this lead to four or even five. You see Bibby pop out. Clydesdale, 10 on the clock. Working on the ball screen. Good defense from
Good
Meg
defense.
Jeffs. She doesn't get the call, and
Bad
Clydesdale
call by the
knocks
referee.
It down. And now Meg Jeffs is going to get a flop warning. And there's 1.4
clear armbar by Amy. And how the officials saw that, and may have been a little bit precious on that one, giving them the flop warning, I think. Sometimes you make a mistake, just got to own that mistake. And two arm bars that she got away with already as well.
So 21-17, and it was an Amy Clydesdale led revival from Dandenong. She's up to 9 points at quarter time, and just as we said a little earlier, that the Blues were doing a great job keeping Dandenong on the perimeter. Clydesdale really took it on herself to get to the rack.
Yep, she was nice and aggressive. She had a quiet start to that game, but yeah, really started to get to the basket and was nice and aggressive. Again, the early foul trouble to Standish kind of hurt the momentum that the Blues had got early on in the quarter. I believe they may be readjusting the foul to Kelly Bowen and putting her back down to one foul. So that was probably why Mike Brookins had left her on. So that's probably a good sign for the Blues.
Well, last week against Sandringham, Kayla Standish and Kelly Bowen combined for 55 points and 29 rebounds. In quarter one, they've got 11 together. Six for Bowen, five for Standish. They lead the way. Tenaya Phillips with five as well. Kelly Bowen leading the way on the boards with five. And for Dandenong, it's Amy Clydesdale with nine. Lauren Scherf with six. And Scherf has got four rebounds as well. And Claire Papavs with two assists. And her and Amy Clydesdale have been combining pretty well in the half court.
Yeah, they run their offense pretty well. You get caught on a screen, they'll find you for an easy layup, and some breakdowns that probably really hurt the VA Lady Blues. People not getting off on the split line, given the last shot that Bree hit. She drove left, probably thought that she was a right-hander, and she was able to get that jump shot. So probably just got to pay a little bit more attention to the scout and be aware of what the range of players' strengths and weaknesses are.
It's the VA Group of Accountants and Advisors. They're the major sponsor of the Lady Blues this season. We thank them for their support.
Big supporters of the club. Don't miss a game, so they've been fantastic first year with the club, and looking forward to a long relationship with them.
Now, one thing that's been noticeable for Dandenong is the lack of substitutions in that first quarter. Of course, no Amelia Todd Hunter so far this season. It'll be interesting to see whether that lack of depth comes into play later in the game. There's Bibby for three. That looked good. Yeah, she had a hand in her face there from Lana Hollingsworth, but it did not matter, and it's a seven-point lead for Dandenong.
So the Lady Blues probably dominated for 7 of the 10 minutes. The late whistle as Standish cops one in the ear.
That was an inadvertent little shimmer there from Sophie Terabolsi.
Yeah, the Lady Blues dominated that first quarter, but a few minutes of poor play, and the Rangers have made it pay. Bowen in the post, go to work.
Some good help from Clydesdale, but she got caught with her hand in the cookie jar. And Kelly Bowen off to the line for two.
Good seeing Bowen in the post there. She's probably been doing more of that this year than what she has in the past, and pick up her 6 or 8 points out of the post. It's probably helped her with her rebounding as well. She's really rebounded well this year. She's got a friendly competition with Kayla Standish on who has more rebounds each game, and Bowen out-rebounded her last week against Sandy, and she's well on track to doing it again today.
Misses both free throws, but good job from Hollingsworth pulling in that offensive rebound. The Lady Blues with 19 offensive rebounds last week against Sandringham. That was a real key to their win. Here's Standish. Look at that spin move. And
beautiful move.
She just went hard at Chloe Bibby and put the pressure on the referee, and she got the call.
Yeah, she was getting to the basket one way or another on that one.
And she's got those long levers, Kayla Standish. It is so tough to keep her out of the paint. So we've played 42 seconds here in the second quarter. It was the Blues who led it 17-10 at one stage. And at last, Kayla Standish breaks that 14-0 run for the Rangers. And after a few enforced minutes on the bench with foul trouble, Standish now up to 7 points. She joins Kelly Bowen on that figure. And last week it was Tenaya Phillips who really stepped up as the third wheel. Let's see if she can do that again this week.
A little zone action here by the Blues. Good mix-up.
Wattman from long range is off. Here's Phillips, but good hustle inside there from Tara Bolsey. I've got a whistle there. I think the shot clock may have reset to 24, so the referee's just getting that in order. It'll be a Dandenong ball. They got 13 on the shot clock. The Blues stick with this zone. It's a 1-2-2. They're packing in the paint. Scherf steps outside to get a little bit of oxygen. Papavs with a hand in her face. She drops another triple.
Loves that three-point shot. Will not hesitate to pull the pin. She didn't have much room to get the shot off, but was able to make the basket.
Somehow Bowen finds Standish. Look at her pivot to the basket and score.
Lauren's still looking for her. She thought she went left and snuck back around on the right.
Now, this is an entertaining game. Important time for the Blues, though. They trail this by 6.
The Blues really need to buckle down at the defensive end, get some stops.
See again, there's four Blues in the paint, just looking to suffocate Scherf inside. This time she gets it at 15 feet. It's a tough shot. Bowen with another rebound. Phillips in the open court. Finds Jeffs. Jeffs to the left hand is off. And Scherf
great
again.
Great fast break. Meg's just got to finish that one.
Now Clydesdale in the open court. Little pass, fake goes right hand. What a move from Clydesdale.
Smart move by Clydesdale, knowing that Standish had 2 fouls. She went straight at her, knowing that she wouldn't put her hand in the cookie jar. And
Phillips goes right back at it the other end, and Kayla Standish cleans it up.
Beautiful offensive board. Good to see Phillips still attacking the ring. But it's this defensive end where the Lady Blues are having trouble at the moment.
Here's Wattman looking inside. Tara Bolsey, she's surrounded by defenders. Good help from Kayla Standish.
A little bit too close for comfort on the foul on that one, but Bowen is the trial three.
Oh, she looked good on that shot, but it's just to the right. And the crowd was just starting to get excited. Noise was starting to build, but now the Rangers, an opportunity to silence the building again. They've scored 19 points in about the last 6 minutes of play. It's Clydesdale, Scherf. Scherf against Standish. She just jabs, steps back and nails it.
Yeah, just too big. She's got a beautiful touch on that jump shot.
Scherf up to 8 points. Amy Clydesdale leads the way for Dandenong with 11. Standish with 9 and Bowen 7 for the Blues. As we see a bit of ball screen action between the two Gonzaga teammates. And nice little feed inside. What a combination they
you
are.
You could hear the Rangers coach saying, pack it in as soon as Bowen or Standish get the ball. I think they're daring the others to make some shots. And unfortunately for the Lady Blues, the Rangers didn't adhere to the coach's instructions and Standish found some space.
Bowen inside, does a good job. Open court opportunity for Phillips. This is where she's at her best. Little crossover. Good job from Papavs to stay in front of her.
Trail three. Big
Bang.
Shot.
Callie Bowen with another
timeout
triple.
Rangers.
Jeremy Moore has seen enough. He says, let's talk about it. And then when it looked like Dandenong might sneak away, it's back to a three-point
game, which has been a little bit like the Lady Blues all year. They've had patches of brilliance and then have either struggled to score or had some lapses on defense, but this one looks like a real entertaining game.
The Blues really look their best when they're aggressive in transition, particularly when Phillips puts her nose down, makes the defense collapse, and then either score or find teammates.
Well, I think that was a perfect illustration, putting heat on the ring and then finding the trailer, and they've got to respect her, they've got to defend her for getting to the basket, so as long as she keeps that aggressive mindset for all 40 minutes, I think the Blues will be in.
Putting her nose down. Challenge from Michael Brookins to really give her that confidence just to go and be herself.
And that's definitely the challenge for her. She's been on a team that's been super successful in the SEABL at Dandenong, and she just had to play her role, whereas now with the Blues she's got to become one of those leading players, and I think she's slowly getting there and had a good week, a good game against Sandringham last week, and off to a good start tonight.
So 5:59 left in the second quarter. It's 31-28, the Rangers leading. I repeated earlier, the Blues on a 2-2 record, the Rangers 2-1. So this is a big, even though it's early in the season, this is a big contest as Scherf steps out. Can't make this one, but it's Clydesdale who comes up with the board. Finds Wattman, that left-handed three-point shot is good. And
look
already
good off the hand, a minute she left it.
Seems Dandenong already have hit three or four little daggers from long range just when the Blues have challenged.
It always seems to be the case as soon as they get an offensive board. Hollingsworth pulls the trigger on the three ball.
Standish inside. Excellent strength from Kayla Standish. Simmons in there as
she
well.
She fought hard, but just a little bit too small against Scherf.
The zone defense again for the Blues. They have done a good job of restricting the post catches, but the Rangers are really starting to punish that zone from outside.
As Mark Jackson would say, hand down, man down. She just made one. Got to respect her on that shot.
Wattman now up to 7 points. Meg Jeffs on the drive, slices through the middle. That's a tough running shot.
Beautiful
from
layup.
Meg Jeffs. She's... You talk about Coach Brookins giving players confidence. Meg Jeffs has obviously got the green light to go to the basket anytime she sees a gap.
Oh, for me, she's been the find of the season so far. Just a completely different player to what she was last year, and really stepping up to the mark. As Hollingsworth, you won't catch her on the break.
One-on-one against Clydesdale. Oh, nice
girl.
Finish from Lana Hollingsworth.
The 15-year-old taking it coast to coast. She had a big game last night for the under-18 Lady Blues VC team with 30 points and carrying on that good form to the SEABL girls.
Here's Scherf inside. Good help from Sammy Simmons. But they leave Wattman open again, and she says, don't you know who I am? I'm the girl who just hit the last two. And now it's the Blues taking a timeout and the Rangers back out by 7.
Well, we spoke about it earlier. Those defensive breakdowns are just killing the Blues at the moment. Well, she's 3 threes in this quarter and been wide open on all three of them.
Bree Wattman moves into double figures. She's got 10 points, and early in the game, some of the full court pressure was giving her a little bit of trouble, but she looks right at home just spotting up on the three-point line.
Played on that two-guard position where she doesn't have to carry the ball and she can just get her feet set and let it fly from the three-point line. As she gets up to, how many points is she up to now?
She's got 10.
Just got to the 10. So, again, the Lady Blues kind of hanging in there, but just defensive breakdowns at the moment are hurting them. I mean, offensively, 32 points with four minutes to go in the quarter. They're on target for a good score, but they've got to get some stops.
So, Michael Brookins, what do you look at here defensively? Because the focus was obviously inside, crowding Lauren Scherf and Chloe Bibby. They've done that well, but now the zone's starting to break down. Do you go back to man? What adjustments do you make?
Well, I think that was the thing. Knowing the scouting report, the zone would probably work if they didn't let Bree shoot that ball. He's gone, taking Standish out, which is a big sub with a seven-point deficit. So potentially back to a man-to-man here, and maybe let Carly defend Scherf on the inside and get a defender on Bree.
Here's Simmons at the top.
The offense has got to come through Bowen now with Phillips and
Kelly Bowen not happy with that pass from Lana Hollingsworth. But Bowen makes up for it. Now there's a low post, a mismatch down low. Good help from Bowen. Papavs lines it up, but she's well off. Chatfield battling inside. And Simmons helps her out, but Scherf somehow comes up with it as it spills loose. And the board's starting to become a bit of an issue for the Rangers, for the Blues. The Rangers pulling in a few offensive boards. That's a tough shot from Clydesdale.
I've said this a few times this year. I don't like having two of the big three off at the same time. And at a crucial time, he's 7 points down. Phillips needs to get back into the game ASAP before this game slips.
3 minutes to play till halftime. Clydesdale going against Simmons. Man defense for the Blues. Scherf rolls inside. Good. Great tracing defense from Carly Chatfield. 3-on-3 fast break, but it's turned over.
Turnovers are really hurting. Getting some stops and then turning the ball over at the other end. Shooter.
Oh, nice feed from Clydesdale to Scherf. And Michael Brookins says, I'm going
to
use another
Phillips back
out
into this game ASAP at Standish before it slips.
And the Blues have done a good job with their foul trouble. When you look up at their star players, Standish had two, but she had them very early on. Kelly Bowen with just one. And Tenaya Phillips yet to pick up a foul, so he can get those girls back
and
into the game.
And unfortunately, he's not in a position when you're 11 down to be able to rest players. He needs to get his studs into the game. And they've probably made a little run. I think Phillips was on the bench a little bit too long. And she can play all game. She's not in foul trouble. So maybe a quick minute break or something and get her back in. And Hollingsworth did a good job holding the fort, but probably had a long stretch where you need to get your studs back into the game.
Yeah, but credit to Dandenong, playing some excellent basketball. You saw them start to break the zone apart. Frankston went to man, and all of a sudden they go to the on-ball screen, Scherf rolling to the basket and finishing, Clydesdale getting into the rim. They know exactly how to execute it.
They've had a really good mix of inside and outside game. Sheriff's been dominating on the inside, and their perimeter players are scoring from the outside. So I think that the Blues will be in this game as long as they can keep it tied. The Rangers aren't very deep. He doesn't like to use the bench at all, so fatigue will kick in that second half, but they don't want to let this blow out any further than what it is already. It's a big 2.5 minutes before halftime.
And they need to just put the ball through the basket a couple of times so they can get their pressure defense going. It's very hard to apply pressure defense when you're scrambling back in transition all the time.
Good to see Standish, Phillips and Bowen all back in together.
Oh, what a move from Kelly Bowen. She just powered her way over her left shoulder. And Kelly moves it up into double figures. She's got 11. So the Blues go to man again. Standish matched up on Scherf. Bowen guarding Bibby. Here's Wattman going at Jeffs. Nice slide from Jeffs. And gee, Kelly Bowen's been active defensively tonight, hasn't she?
Yeah, had those active hands ready and getting deflections and
just under 2 minutes to play until halftime. Shot clock at 5.
Good job, Meg Jeffs, getting down on the floor. Here comes the fast break again.
Two on
the
two.
The Gonzaga fast break.
is Standish. Nice defense though from Papavs. Bowen sliding on the floor.
Good job, Kelly, getting down.
Now Phillips to the pull-up. Rattles around and out. Unlucky there for Tenaya Phillips. There's a big 90 seconds to come until halftime. 7-point ball game. Let's see if the Blues can lock down defensively. Scherf just faces up again. This one's off the mark.
Another offensive board to the Rangers.
There's that 3-point shot.
And they make it pay every time.
Off the offensive board.
Phillips trying to use their athletic ability to get the rebound instead of putting a body on Amy, and was made to pay.
There's that. There's a tough angle for Jeffs there. It's deflected out of court. That combination between Papavs and Clydesdale has been so effective tonight.
They've played together for so many years. They know each other back to front.
58 seconds to play. It's a 10-point ball game. Here's
nice
Bowen
execution.
Inside. She's denied the first time. She goes again and she draws the foul on Bibby.
Beautiful execution on the baseline play. Nice bounce pass by Sammy Simmons, and hopefully Bowen can knock him down from the line.
Bowen is so tough to stop in that end line situation. She's such a strong player that when she's cutting and curling, it's very hard to bump her and keep her from where she wants to go.
And they're so worried about her perimeter game as well. So adding a little post game and inside presence makes her a hell of a lot tougher to defend.
She makes both. And her ability to catch and release and get it off quickly from those inbounds plays is really dangerous too.
Well, the Blues have done pretty well all year with those baseline plays. So
a little bit of an issue here with the bench. You may be able to hear in the background that they don't have a number 12 on their score sheet. That's Maxine Allen, who's checked into the ball game, but someone forgot to write her name down. We just got a little bit of a pause, so I'll take you through some of the leaders for Dandenong. Amy Clydesdale with 14 points and 4 assists. Got a couple of boards for good measure as well. Bree Wattman's got 10 points. Lauren Scherf with 10 and 7 boards as well. And for Frankston, Kelly Bowen and Kayla Standish both have 13 points. Kelly Bowen with 8 boards to go with that. But it's the third scorer where no one's quite stepped up yet. Tenaya Phillips had that little burst with 5 points.
Yeah.
But we've seen Chatfield miss a couple. Meg Jeffs has been aggressive.
Phillips with only 4 shot attempts, for me, is just not enough. She needs to get, 16, 18 field goal attempts every game, and she's below average, I think, at this stage in the game. Little 1-2-2 full court press here.
And it comes up with a result. Bowen
good job,
on the
Lady
floor.
Blues.
There's Simmons.
Oh.
To Jeffs. Oh, and a little lack of composure there on the fast break.
Might have got away with one then.
Now Simmons from the corner, and she nails it.
I like that mix-up by Mike Brookins, going into a little trap just before, with a couple of inexperienced guards on the floor.
Oh, and a soft foul call there on Sammy Simmons. Just the first for the quarter, though, on Frankston.
That's all right.
And we talked about, it's just so important to get the ball through the hoop so you can set up those presses, because Dandenong have looked a little bit shaky against that. So 32 seconds to run until halftime. It's a 6-point ball game, so a couple of really big possessions here for one side or the other to take some momentum in. Nice on-ball execution and rolling to the basket. Tara Bolsey finishes on an outstanding feed from Bree Wattman.
Again, that split line, Bowen was a second late. She probably, if she was on that split line, probably would have intercepted that pass. And an easy 2 points as Tori Jackson checks into the game nice and early. She made her debut last week against Geelong and played the last minute of the game, but putting in there for the last 21 seconds before halftime.
So final play of the half. It's now out to 9 points the difference. So who do you go to here if you're the Blues?
A little pick and roll action with Phillips and Bowen or Standish, which they're running a little horn set here. Might have
Standish
got trouble there, yeah.
And she had a wide open Kelly Bowen. She just got a little too enthusiastic trying to find her. And Jeremy Moll calls a timeout for Dandenong with 8.1 seconds left until halftime. Defensively here, if you're the Blues, do you mix it up? Do you go back to a zone? Do you try and stun someone on the inbounds pass with a double team? What do you go with?
It'll be interesting to see. Out of the last time out, he went into that 1-2-2 trap. High risk. high reward as well, I guess. So I'm probably thinking maybe just a solid man-to-man here and make her take a contested shot. I'll be getting Standish out of the game, making sure she doesn't pick up a third before halftime. And then, yeah, going to that break, hopefully nine down and not double figures.
Well, Amy Clydesdale's on the bench at the moment for Dandenong. She's been the one that has really made the difference getting into the lane. So perhaps they'll put the ball in the hands of Watman again and go to that on-ball situation that's worked for them this quarter.
Yeah, well, they potentially might throw it in deep to Scherf once they get it over half court and let her go to work out of the post if she's into the game. No, she's on the bench, so...
So I think we might see some action, perhaps between Bibby and Watman.
Yep. Little on-ball action, I reckon, between those two.
They've got 15 points between them for the half.
Got to be ready for Bibby because she can shoot that three.
There is that trap. Clock down to five. Strong drive. Good help there from Bjellin. Now Carly Chatfield gets the board, and that's half-time. So there's a little bit of a risky strategy, but it paid dividends in the end, and the Blues restrict any further damage. So it's half-time here at the Frankston Basketball Stadium. It's the Anzac Day traditional matchup between Frankston and Dandenong. We've had a soaring half so far, but it's the Rangers in the lead, 47-38. I'll run you through some of the scorers quickly before we have a break for halftime. Clydesdale with 14, Watman and Scherf with 10 for the Rangers. And for Frankston, the Gonzaga connection, Kelly Bowen and Kayla Standish with 13 apiece. They've got 12 boards between them as well. And on the glass for Dandenong, Scherf with 7 and Papavs with 6. And in terms of assists, Papavs, Watman and Clydesdale have dished off 10 between them. Dandenong's execution has been outstanding so far. The Blues have hung tough, though. They've shown their pressure defense can get them back into this ball game if they can create some open court looks. We'll be back here in about 12 minutes' time for the second half. Make sure you join us then.
I'm from nights where I'm on my
With the break in play, we'll take a look at the box score for both sides. For your Frankston Lady Blues, two players on 13 points in Kelly Bowen and Kayla Standish. KBO closing in on that double-double, just two rebounds shy. She's got 13 and 8 as a stat line. While for the Rangers, they've been led by Amy Clydesdale, shooting at 75% with four dimes to her name. While Bree Wattman and Lauren Scherf also have 10 points, the rebound battle team versus team. It's all locked at heads at 17.
Since we've kicked it, and I can't lie, I've missed it, but somewhere the current shifted, and now I'm somewhere else. Far away for light, we drifted. Hard to face the facts. I'm drinking to escape. I'm making get swept under the rug till I'm tripping on a pile. Need to change something different for a while. Yeah, we grew apart with time. We ain't kicked it in a while, but I still think about you now. Without you, see there's differences now. But it happens. How could we have known? Nothing can prepare us from sleeping at your parents. Now to sold out shows in Paris, to parties at my hotels, ashing off my terrace. Tell me how we ever come to live this careless.
Tell me now. Once again, I don't know where I am. Ooh. I just know I'm drifting far from you. Yeah. Trying to keep my head strong, but my heart won't just let me go away from you. Don't you know we're drifting off? Hope and disregard, drifting off. I know you think there ain't no fall that far apart. And now I'm missing your love.
That's her.
Have you ever been lied to? Got drunk, got high too. Had sex on the first night, and it was just alright. You just wanna have fun, you just wanna wild out. You just wanna stun on your ex with your next night. Bitch, eat your heart out.
Take me with you right now. Right now, yeah. Put it on me right now. Right now. Freaking, I can't help it. Bring your girlfriend, don't be selfish. Tonight is what we make it. You bring it out of me. I'm just a freaking, I can't help it. Bring your girlfriend, don't be selfish. Tonight is what we make it. You bring it out.
In the city, got you feeling me. Smoke weed in the club for security. And my enemies, bottles up. If you get money, we're the pretty girls. What's up?
Take me with you right now. Right now.
Right now.
Put it on me right now. Right now. Right now. The freaking, I can't help it. When your girlfriend, don't be selfish. Tonight is what we make it. You bring it out of me. I'm just a freaking, I can't help it. When your girlfriend, don't be selfish. Tonight is what we make it.
Nothing I can do when you're near, when you're near. I don't have control, I don't have control.
I'm just a freaking, I can't help it. Bring your girlfriend, don't be selfish. Tonight is what we make it. You bring it out of me.
Don't tell, don't tell, you don't
tell him, don't tell him, don't tell him. You ain't need, don't tell him, don't tell him. You ain't need, you ain't need. Gotta tell him, don't tell him, don't tell him.
Welcome back to Blues Basketball Media. Just under a minute to go until the third quarter. As I said, at halftime, it was a seesawing first half. It's 47-38 to the Blues. I'm Paulo Kennedy. I'm joined by Steve Blackley. And Steve, here we talk about that 9-point margin. What have the Blues got to change to bring that back?
I think just some work on their defensive rotations and probably allowed some split line layups and uncontested threes probably hurt them as well. So yeah, not much in the game.
We talked about the zone, and eventually Dandenong broke it open and hit those 3-point shots. You talk about the man-to-man defense, and they had a lot of trouble guarding the ball screen, and 47 points is a lot to give up at halftime. Do they need to switch between those two a little bit more quickly to disrupt the rhythm of Dandenong?
I think you're right. They're going to start in a zone again. I was in the rooms at halftime. They're starting in a zone. I'd like to see them mix it up between man and zone. I think they're a little bit worried about Standish's two early fouls. So maybe they might try and get through this first bit of the third quarter to nurse Standish through and then maybe get hit up with some man-to-man.
And we talked about Dandenong with their shortened rotation. So so important the Blues can just hang around and force them to play this one out for the full 40 minutes, and that means getting a couple of early scores here in the third quarter, and that's just what the doctor ordered.
Beautiful set in a little weave set, and Standish hitting the mid-range.
And here's little, that pressing yep. defense again. Every time they score, it seems they're putting some heat on the Dandenong guards.
Mouse in the house.
Scherf falls away.
Got away with it. And if nothing else, that trap will really speed up the offense, make them take some bad shots.
Well, we talked about how good Dandenong's execution is, and how good is Kayla Standish. She's up to 17 points, and just like that, it's back to a 5-point ball game.
She may have got away with a little hop on that one too, but we'll take that.
Sammy Simmons.
Good start to the Blues.
In fact, it was Jeff's getting a hand on that pass, but Bibby recovered it. The shot clock, though, already down to 9, and Dandenong haven't got into anything yet. Shot clock now at 4. Clydesdale's going to have to fire. She does, and she connects. And Dandenong continue to punish Frankston from long range.
They are lights out from the 3-point line. 6 of 10 from the 3-point line already.
Kelly Bowen lights out as well. She's up to 15 points. 32 points for the Gonzaga connection. And the Blues hanging around. There's trapping defense again, but Bowen puts her hand in the cookie jar. That's her second foul for the game. So Papavs inbounding, looking inside to Scherf. Good help there from Bowen, who read the play. She'd seen that one in the first half.
That was that rotation that we didn't have in the first half.
So a 6-point ball game. It's 50-44. Dandenong in the lead. Clydesdale, she's been doing the damage for the ladies in white. She's got 17 points. Bibby to a tough pull-up. That one's off the mark, and Standish does a good job boxing out Lauren Scherf, and now Phillips in transition. Nice passing inside. Double-team Standish, and that help from Wattman was enough to force a miss.
Yeah, she'll be disappointed with that one. She got the nice deep seal and didn't get the finish.
Man defense now from the Blues, so they are starting to mix it up a little bit more, but Clydesdale gets into the lane and draws a foul.
She had her, she played pretty good defense and then reached in at that last second and drew the foul.
So Clydesdale, as I said, 17 points and 4 assists already in just 21 minutes of action. And the Blues are going to have to find some way to keep her out of the lane. Of course, we saw on the previous possession, she nailed her second triple. She's 2 of 2, so it's not an easy scout, is it?
No, but when she's got the ability to get to the rack, she's really athletic and then shoots the three ball well. It's a tough matchup.
So a little bit of pressure here from the Rangers. Jeff turns it over. 2-on-1. Clydesdale to Wattman, and the Blues getting a little bit of their own medicine there.
Just like that, it's back out to 10 after a good start to the third quarter.
Here's Jeff. She was aggressive early going to the basket. At times she's closed down. Here's Standish from long range. It'll come back to her. Phillips, she doesn't hesitate on that one, and she cans the little mid-range jump shot.
Again, offensively, they're not having any trouble scoring. It's just getting some stops down at the defensive end.
The Blues shooting the ball at over 50% from the floor. Just trying to stop what's a bit of a juggernaut from Dandenong as Watman.
Good job on the board,
that.
Standish.
Here's the Gonzaga fast break again. Bowen pulls up and connects from mid-range. 17 points for Kelly Bowen, and it's back to six. It's like being on a roller coaster watching this one. The Blues in some pressure. This time Watman doesn't have any trouble. What a feed inside from Clydesdale. But Standish blocks the shot, and Bibby picks up the foul, so the Blues dodge a bullet on that one.
I think they were lucky. Bowen fell asleep on that one, and should have been an open layup to Lauren Scherf, but they dodged a bullet and get to eat into this lead now, down to six, and with a chance to bring it back to four.
It was so important they didn't let Dandenong get away early in this quarter. Now they start putting the pressure on then as Tenaya Phillips calls for a horn set. Let's see if she'll go to the basket.
There it is.
Bowen will take it to the rim. Tough shot from Bowen. Standish inside. Gets the board. Finishes the job.
That horn set's good. It made Scherf had to show on the on-ball screen, which brought her away from the basket, which allowed Standish to clean up the offensive board.
Dandenong passed their way through that press. Now some much better ball movement from
weak side help again.
Quick hand from Standish, and Phillips pounces. Blues again in transition. They look so dangerous in the open floor. Standish, a tough shot.
That was a tough one. Little heat check on that one, but again, I like the fact that they're out and running and trying to get things done early in transition.
Well, when you've got 19 points in 17 minutes, you're allowed a heat check. Bibby dives to the basket.
Really need to lock down to 8 seconds.
Papavs to a tough
shot.
Good gloves,
Phillips.
Standish away. She's got Watman to beat.
On the breakaway, she might dunk this. Oh, she missed the layup.
Good hustle from Bree Watman. She just did enough to force it to be a tougher shot than Standish was expecting.
I love the tempo the Blues have come out with in this third quarter, really pushing the ball offensively.
Clydesdale from mid-range.
Again, Simmons too late with the hand up, and you just can't afford to allow that to happen to a player, the ability of Amy Clydesdale.
She's got 21 points, puts the margin out to six. Simmons tries to make up for it at the other end, but she can't. And again, the momentum just starting to swing a little bit. So we see Meg Jeffs getting up and in. There's been no questioning her commitment so far tonight. There's Clydesdale to the pull-up. She is just motoring tonight. And Michael Brooken says, I've got to talk about how we can stop number five.
I'm not sure what happened on that defensive rotation on the on-ball. There was no show. Sammy was hung out to dry, got caught on the pick, and Clydesdale made the easy 10-footer.
So we're midway through the third quarter. It's 58-50. What do you like about what the Blues have done so far this quarter?
Well, again, they look good. They're out of the blocks nice and early. They were running in transition. And again, last two possessions, defensive breakdowns. They had it back to 4 points and were back out to eight again. Until they lock in defensively every possession, this is going to continue to happen. So they really need to make a focus on the defensive end.
We saw that pressure defense giving Dandenong some trouble early, but then they started passing their way through it. Is it time to go to a bit of full court man, maybe a little run and jump, or maybe just dropping it back to half court?
Potentially, I think definitely they need to get back to man to man. The zone's probably, they've probably worked it out, and if you stay in for something in something too long, you know, the good teams and the good coaches will work it out. So either mixing it up or going back to a man set will probably help the Blues.
Jeremy Mole, the Dandenong coach, plenty of experience. He coached Adelaide in the WNBL. He was an assistant coach on those title-winning Bendigo Spirit teams, so he knows the game of basketball pretty well. He's done a good job so far tonight. This horn set again. This looks great, doesn't it? The three gun players all involved. There's Simmons from the corner. Jeff's fighting inside, and she was held by Bree Watman, but they're going to call Meg Jeffs for the foul. Got to love that hustle from the youngster.
Yeah, no, she's really having a good game, impacting at both ends, and nice block out though by Clydesdale.
And that's the execution was good there. You need a player like Sammy Simmons to hit those mid-range shots. As Scherf inside, good defense from Standish.
I think Scherf might have been blinded by the light then as the scoreboard went to an all-white look, but Blues got away with one then.
Standish has been doing a pretty good job inside. She's just held her ground and made Scherf shoot shots going away from the basket rather than those easy little layups she was getting very early on in the piece as that one goes out of bounds off Kelly Bowen. Kelly didn't like the call, but it will go to Dandenong. They've got a chance to extend the margin back out to double figures.
And this is where we need some of our star players to lock in defensively. They've got to buy in and really defend.
Good defense from Simmons there. And we see a turnover result. Scramble for the ball. Clydesdale comes up with it. Double team from Simmons. Shot clock down to four.
Hurt.
Bibby from the corner nails it. A line drive triple from Chloe Bibby after Frankston had all but come up with the steal. And now the margin is back out to 11. Standish inside. Classy finish. And yet again, it's Bowen and Standish combining to keep the Blues in touch.
And no subs by either team so far this quarter. Both teams the line to go with their starters. So interesting to see who's the first team to go to that bench.
Which coach will blink first? Double team again on Papavs. And it's a 5-second violation. And there's the dynamic duo of Jeffs and Simmons making something happen defensively.
And the Blues have done a great job guarding Papavs tonight. Held her to 5 points and really hasn't got off the leash yet. So credit to the Blues for defending her tough.
Early on, she was creating some troubles with her passing game, but the reason closed down on that as Bowen forces the foul on Papavs there. That's her third for the game. So she's the first player in a little bit of foul trouble for Dandenong.
And what does Jeremy Muir now, does he take her out or roll with her on three fouls? I think he's electing to roll with her, so interesting move.
There's Standish inside. Good defense from Scherf, and she does enough to force Standish out of the basket. Clydesdale in the open court. Good help from Jeff. She forced the turnover.
Here they go.
There.
Three on one.
Ooh, Phillips went to the left. She found Jeff's. Now she's going to pop it from long range. The lefty triple is off. And that's going to be a foul caught on Standish. That was a soft one. But regardless, that's her third foul. Michael Brookins claps his hands and says, what was that? We got a warning to Jeremy Mule, but I'm not sure what that was for. He's not sure either. He extends his arms in bemusement.
It's pretty hard to get a warning when you get the call go your way, so he's still a bit bemused.
That was the referee who gave the flop warning earlier in the game against Meg Jeffs, which we weren't too sure about. But he's certainly keen to stamp his authority on this ball game as we see the Blues in man-to-man defense. Clydesdale outside. Simmons did a good job, and now she's inside helping out. And Bowen comes up with the steal. Can we see Phillips go all the way? We can, to the left hand. She finishes, and she just looks so much better when she backs her ability.
And probably something she should have done on that last fast break. We had a 3-on-1 fast break and ended up getting a 3-point shot out of it. So good attacking play by Phillips.
9 points now for Tenaya Phillips. The Blues scrambling again. A fall away from Scherf is good.
Scherf camping in that key for more than the allotted time, I would think.
She's up to 12 points. Like you said, though, just at the moment, the tempo feels pretty good for the Blues, but I'm not sure about that one from Kayla Standish.
Might have been a bit early.
Here's Clydesdale. Assessing her options. Good screen there from Lauren Scherf, but Tenaya Phillips did enough to force her out. Bibby comes up with it. She's fouled by Bowen. That's foul number three on Kelly. So the Blues just falling away in a couple of the effort areas. Dandenong extending this lead back out to 9, a chance to make it 11.
I'm not sure if I've seen a game at this level go through for nearly 8 minutes with either team making a sub as Carly Chatfield comes in for Kayla Standish.
So 3 fouls on Standish, 3 on Bowen. The only player in foul trouble for the Rangers is Claire Papavs. She has 3 herself. She's still out in the ball game. Dandenong riding their starters so far in this game. Bibby makes the second, so it's a 10-point. She has 9 points herself. 2-3 zone that the Rangers fall back into. And Phillips, that's off the marks. And there'll be a Rangers ball, but every Dandenong starter has played more than 25 of the 28 and a half minutes so far in this game.
And I think Frankston really need to lift from Chatfield off that bench. Even if it's just defensively and on the boards, we really need something out of her.
So you're guarding Chloe Bibby in the low post. Shot clock at 10. Papavs working against Jeffs. Here is the matchup we're talking about. Bibby
man
fires.
Down, man down.
From 20 feet, she looked very comfortable. She moves to 11 points. The margin moves to 12. Phillips inside, spins to the left and finishes. It doesn't seem like anyone can stop Tenaya Phillips when she puts her nose down and gets to the rim.
Well, she needs to keep attacking, and she's had 5 shots this quarter, which was as many as she had in the entire first half. So,
Bibby to the baseline, she draws the foul on Bibby.
Bad closeout on Chatfield on that occasion.
That's going to be bonus free throws, 5 team fouls on Frankston this quarter, and with 39 seconds to go, it's so important that Frankston get a score on this next possession. Do you go back to that horn set that they were running earlier in the quarter?
Yeah, or even just a pick and roll set with Bowen and Phillips, and maybe spread the floor with shooters in the corners and see what make Phillips make a play out of that.
I think even against this 2-3 zone, I'd like to see that screen action at the top of the key. See if that draws Lauren Scherf away from the basket. If not, you get some pull-up opportunities at mid-range.
Yeah, which is what they were able to do at the start of that third quarter.
2-2-1 press. There's about 12 seconds between shot and game clock, so Dandenong will get another chance. It's left with Meg Jeff. Shot clock at 10. Feeds it to Bowen. She's surrounded. Out to Chatfield. Can she connect? Yes, she can. Finally, Carly Chatfield gets that jumper to go.
Hopefully that'll give us some confidence for this last quarter.
Simmons up the floor, harassing Clydesdale. Bibby pulls up at the free throw line and
Bibby's
connects.
Just absolutely smashing the Blues with that mid-range game.
Last shot from Phillips is off the mark, and after it looked like Frankston had closed in, they got that margin back to 4 midway through that quarter, but Dandenong showed their class. And at three-quarter time, they lead at 70-58, behind 23 points from A.B. Clydesdale. She's dished out 6 assists as well. It's been a masterclass.
Well, she's definitely been the star of this game at both ends, facilitating to her teammates, scoring heavily herself. Steals as well. She's leading the team in steals, so definitely impacting the game everywhere at the moment. So the Blues are in a little bit of trouble, down 12, and they're just not getting it done defensively. Offensively, they're fine, but defensively, people just losing rotations and missing blockouts, and they're just not on sync together.
4 Rangers in double figures. Chloe Bibby now up to 15 points.
I think she's been the quiet achiever. She's hardly missed a shot. That mid-range is jumper for her is money, and every time we seem to make a run, Bibby seems to hit a big shot.
Yeah, the Blues have really found it hard to know who to rotate off, because all those role players for Dandenong just seem to make the open shot when it's there.
Yeah, they've all stepped up, but I think the only thing potentially in the Blues' favour is the Rangers maybe getting a little tired and not using the bench at all that quarter, so that can be something maybe that can work in their favour, but again, unless they lock in as a team defensively, you know, it's going to be too big of a margin to overturn.
I think they need to look to get the ball more to Kayla Standish at that high post region where she can go to either hand, she can pull up, pivot to the basket. Now, she's been excellent. She's got 21 points so far today. Kelly Bowen with 17, 12 rebounds and 4 assists. Those two have been outstanding. Tenaya Phillips stepped up late. She's got 11 points, but I think if you look at this final quarter, the Blues are going to have to probably score at least 25 points this quarter to get the win.
Yeah, but it's going to be a big ask, and I'm tipping if the Rangers score more than 84, 85 points, it's going to be a tough one to overcome. So 12 points is a big margin. Anything's possible, I guess.
Well, so far, just 9 points off turnovers for Frankston. They looked very dangerous early. They had a patch early in the third quarter where they got some steals. I think it's going to have to come down to the effort of Simmons, Jeffs, and Tenaya Phillips up the floor. But they're going to need that next line of defenders to be really aggressive as well, so they can't just make that easy pass to Bibby for an open jump shot.
Yep. And they shut down Watman that quarter, but Bibby got off the chain, and so did...
There is Watman.
And so did Clydesdale.
Firing from long range. Frankston will take that rush shot. That was an ambitious pass from Kelly Bowen.
Left hand, no look pass.
Clydesdale down the middle. Tough shot.
And Hamey makes
around
it play.
And every time the Blues turn it over, the Rangers are so clinical in transition. And Amy Clydesdale moves up to 25 points on the night.
Oh, that's a tough pass.
Oh, well fought inside by Kelly Bowen. She made something out of nothing there.
Lucky to get away with that one. Good recovery by Kelly Bowen on a bad entry pass from Sammy.
So the margin's 12. The Lady Blues are close enough if they're good enough. Here's Clydesdale. That's one lady you can't let drive into the lane like that, but good hustle. That was Kelly Bowen getting down on the floor. She's done just about everything tonight. If you go over her stats, 17 points, 13 rebounds, 4 assists, and you can throw a steal in there for good measure.
And some loose ball hustle.
So the Rangers back to man-on-man. A little bit of shuffle offense from the Blues as Kelly Bowen tumbles hard. Here is Standish at the top, taking it straight at Lauren Scherf. And that's the spot you want her with the basketball.
And that's where you need to attack Lauren Scherf from the perimeter. Get it on the floor and get to the rack.
How about her ability just to go to the left? And she made that look easy, but that was a layup from the side of the key.
Yep, with the left hand. Now she's all class.
Here is Scherf at the top. She's shown us she can hit that jumper. Shot clock at 7. Clydesdale, she's hit Bang. 2, she's hit 3. Amy Clydesdale, perfect from long range, and she keeps the Blues at bay.
And again, Simmons just caught too far away from... As we come back and nail it down, so they're not going away just yet, the Lady Blues.
Kelly Bowen hits her second three. She's got 22 points. We've had a shootout here on Anzac Day. It's 75-65. The Blues just hanging around.
Happy to see the Blues back into a man-to-man defense and... put some responsibility on people to actually defend.
There, Simmons does a good job back
Scherf
time.
For 3.
Big shot from Scherf is off the
All
mark.
All right, good stop. Here they go. Big possession right here.
You can hear the crowd just starting to lift. They understand it might be now or never for the Blues. Tough shot for Bowen. Look at Standish inside. Who will that foul be called on? It's called on Frankston.
Oh.
Unbelievable call. In fact, I'm not sure who the foul's been called. She said 32 Frankston.
She said 32.
She's pointed Frankston's way. An incredible call there from the referee. Bree Watman tunneling underneath the back of Standish.
It may have been about her first call she's made all night and made a howler on that one.
And just the momentum that the Blues had built up drains away. What can the Rangers do here? Scherf thinks about the three-point shot. The defense
goes, Phillips,
has gone up a level.
You won't catch
her. Floor. She stops, she pops, and hits a layup off the glass. And Jeremy Muell has seen enough. It's back to 8. And we've still got 7 minutes to run. And once again, it's the pressure defense of Frankston forcing the turnover there. And we talked about points off turnovers. That's exactly what they need.
Well, a little bit of defensive pressure and getting in the lanes and getting out and run, get some easy baskets. So...
see this game.
Interesting substitution here with Standish coming out of the game. Not sure with that fourth foul, probably can't keep her out for too much longer, but with an 8-point deficit, to maybe just have a look for a couple of minutes to see whether they can kind of keep that momentum going and get her back in maybe for the last 5 minutes.
How long do you leave her out? 2 minutes?
2 minutes at the max.
Is it one where you're tempted just to leave her in because the Blues are on a roll, they're back to 8?
Yeah, me personally, with this timeout, you know, being 8 down, maybe give her a couple of possessions, but it really is a touch and go call. I'd probably like to see her stay out there because we've got that momentum, but you know, a couple of bad possessions and the lead goes back out to 12 or 13 again, and that game's over. So,
is it one? If you were coaching the Blues, would you think about going back to the 3 big lineup? going to a zone defense with Carly Chatfield in the middle, perhaps.
I think that man-to-man's working, so... but then, yeah, potentially going with Chatfield so she can guard Scherf might be an option.
Here she is guarding Scherf at the top of the key. There's real intensity about the Frankston defense now. Simmons sliding in front of Clydesdale. Good help from Chatfield. She forces the miss. Now Phillips with a little bounce in a step in transition. Looking to go at... Oh, tough move to the right hand. She draws the foul on Watman.
Huge
and she
play.
Makes the basket.
Beautiful crossover and then got the hesitation and finished with the right hand on the ring. And that's why we got her over from the Dandenong Rangers for plays like that.
She is up to 15 points for the night. She's really come to life. In about the last 10 minutes of play, she's really decided it's up to her to make something happen.
Which with Standish off, this is when she needs to be aggressive.
This is the free throw, but it's a six-point game, and potentially a two-possession ball game. Pressure defense again from the Blues. Dandenong showing some good composure against that.
Pappas for three.
Pappas, long shot is off the mark. And Dandenong's
Chatfield with two nice rebounds. Fantastic block out on Scherf.
Dandenong have gone cold from long range. Phillips. Chatfield.
She needs to get it through Bowen and Stand and Phillips' hand.
Simmons for three. Big shot from
Simmons.
Simmons.
Maybe her biggest shot of her career, getting the girls back into the game.
She did not hesitate. It is a three-point ball game. The Blues are up and in. They think this one's there for the taking. 5:45 to run until the end. Look at Simmons all over Papavs in the corner. Shot clock at eight. Clydesdale somehow finds Bibby. She
good
takes
defense,
it at
Phillips.
Tough shot. Oh, my goodness. Claire Bibby, Chloe Bibby with the fall away. She has been money in the second half. Simmons goes again for three. Rims up, rims off.
That was dead straight, too.
This game has been frenetic the last couple of minutes. The Blues are making a charge, but they've got to get a stop here.
I love the confidence Simmons had to pull the trigger. She wouldn't have done that 12 months ago, which is fantastic to see. Big stop here.
High pass, clever pass from Papavs to Scherf.
It was a really smart pass. She threw it up near the ceiling, knowing that no one could get it except Scherf. Time to get Standish back into the game, Paulo.
Scherf up to 14. Jeffs to the basket. Finds Chatfield. She hit her last one.
That time to get short. Her. Time to get her in.
And as you say that, Kayla Standish up to the bench. 4:40 to play.
This is the problem. If there's no whistle for the next minute or two, we've got her sitting on the best player in the league sitting on the bench. So.
Do you instruct someone to foul away from the basket?
Potentially.
Tough drive. Bibby inside. Good help from Sammy
Simmons.
She has
just been unbelievable tonight.
Bibby up to 19 points. She has hit tough shot after tough shot. And she's made plenty of easy ones too. 9-point ball game. Bowen to Chatfield. Pull up going right. It's just out. And this is where they do need someone to foul.
It's fair to say that move to put Standish on the bench has backfired now with the margin going back out to nine.
Worked for a couple of minutes.
Yep,
as
now
said,
that momentum's gone.
Bowen with the steal. Watman puts her hands in. Under 4 minutes, Bowen to the foul line. Pulls up and misses.
We just haven't got anyone on the glass with Standish on. And I think you're about right. Almost time to give up a foul just to get Standish on.
Only one team foul for each team so far this quarter. Bowen gets up and fouls. She's a smart player. She knew what was going on there, and she gets her buddy back into the ball game.
We'll give her credit for that one. Professional foul. But probably
wasn't
meaning
it.
No, it's her fourth foul, so that probably hurts her a little bit as well.
Indeed, and she gave the referee a little stare just as she walked off the court there. And that was one where we needed one of the guards up the floor to commit the foul. And so now the Blues will walk a tightrope for the final 3:37 with both Standish and Bowen on four fouls. Does that impact the way they've got to play?
I don't think it can. They've got to get every stop that they can. They've got to be aggressive on the offensive end. I'll be going through Standish in the post, and if they double kick it out to shooters or maybe some pick and roll action with Phillips. But that momentum they had just kind of got sucked out of the gym. With that Chloe Bibby fadeaway jump shot. That was an outstanding shot for me. She's almost been the... I know Clydesdale's been the star with the numbers, but Bibby's just hit big shot after big shot all game.
Yeah, we talked about Clydesdale. We've talked plenty about Scherf. And in the first half, it was Bree Watman who stepped up into the breach. The second half, it's been Chloe Bibby. We saw the drive from the high post by Kayla Standish earlier. In the first half, we saw some nice high-low action between Standish and Bowen. Perhaps we'll see that ball screen action again.
Yeah, and I think you're going to have to see the Blues in some sort of press here as well. I don't think they can afford to just go through the motions of playing half-court man-to-man. They need to take some gambles and see if they can get some easy scores.
There's Simmons up and in. Pull-up shot from Clydesdale is off the mark, so the Blues hang around.
Get on the ring, T.
3-on-2 fast break. Find Standish. And we just love seeing Tenaya Phillips go to the rim. Yep. Good things happen when she goes herself.
Yeah, but I'd like to see her get on the glass.
Simmons again up in the shorts of Amy Clydesdale. It's been no lack of effort from Sammy Simmons or Meg Jeffs, who's guarding Watman. Clydesdale for three. No good this time.
Oh, that hurt.
Scherf steps back. Can't connect. Bowen with another rebound.
They've dodged a couple of bullets on that.
Bowen with rebound number 14. Now she goes inside to Standish and draws the foul. And it's not just Phillips who looks good, but Standish and Bowen look great when they put their nose down and get into the defense.
No, absolutely. The entire Lady Blues team look good out in transition when they can get out and run.
Just 11 fouls for the game on the Rangers, and that perhaps tells the story that the Blues do need to be more aggressive going to the basket.
They try and get Scherf and those big girls in foul trouble nice and early, but it's probably a little bit too late maybe.
Standish makes both. She's got 25 for the game.
Some full court pressure here.
7 points the difference. It's not over yet, folks.
Oh, here it might be here. Bibby. Oh, here we go. It's a lucky
Standish.
One. That was another break. That's that high risk defense. They throw a bounce pass to Scherf's ankles and got away with it. So big possession right here.
We saw that pass earlier from Papavs, the high looping pass to Scherf. That's the one that Chloe Bibby needed to go with there. Standish to the basket. She's fouled by Scherf.
Off the dribble again with that left hand. That's that go-to move. Get her the ball in the low post and get out of the way.
What I really liked about that was how quick the ball movement was, so that the help defense didn't have time to get to that drive by Standish. And she got it, just ripped to that left hand and went. She can bring it back to 5 points here. The Blues continue to challenge.
Oh, that hurt. Stay in some full court pressure after this free throw, Paulo, and see if they can force another turnover.
She makes that. 26 points for Standish, 22 for Bowen, and 15 for Phillips. Here's Papavs under pressure from Jeffs, who fouls. Just the third team foul so far. Michael Brookins is up in the ear of the referee.
Well, I think he's a little upset that the two male officials seem to be overruling the young female referee. Probably was her call, and a little bit frustrated with that.
Scherf in a little two-man game with Clydesdale.
Would have loved to have seen this defensive intensity early in the game. Bibby, that might be the big one.
She misses this one.
Oh, missed the block out.
Gets the O-board. Good help from Simmons. Somehow the ball squeezes out to Watman.
Oh.
Clydesdale's hit three. Again.
Another offensive
rebound.
Board.
And what do we got here? We've got something happening off the ball. In fact, the referee not happy with the shot clock reset. He wants to put it to six, I think he's saying. So is he saying that three-point shot
didn't hit the ring, I think.
So 6 on the clock, 2 minutes to play in the game, and it's a 6-point ball game. Blues have to get a stop here.
Look at him throw the ball into... Oh, there's a steal!
Simmons
on the fast break.
One-on-one with Clydesdale. She goes to the left hand.
Blown the layup. That really hurts.
Ball still in dispute. 3 seconds to get it over half court, and Clydesdale gets it over with one to spare.
The Blues have had their chances this last minute and a half. They just haven't taken them.
Watman to the baseline. That's a tough shot from Bree Watman.
That was pretty good defense by Meg Jeffs.
Standish recovers the spilt ball. Goes at Scherf. Bowen with the offensive board. She's blocked by Scherf. And Dandenong just seemed to have the answers at the moment.
The young referee seemed to have put his whistle away on both those plays.
So 1:20 to play. It's almost beyond reach now as Sammy Simmons fouls. That's the fourth on Frankston. So from here, do you start strategically fouling from here?
Yeah, I think it's time, but the problem is those Ranger girls, all five of them out there, are terrific free throw shooters. So maybe just go whoever catches it first. And
there's Bibby. She hasn't missed much tonight, Chloe Bibby. Clydesdale, a little reach in from Simmons. Tough drive, fine Scherf.
Game over.
And just as the game
started.
That
was a nail in the coffin right there. Beautiful pass by Clydesdale.
Clydesdale with assist number 7. Phillips inside to Bowen. She is surrounded and she's blocked. And Watman draws a foul on Kayla Standish. And that is good night, Kayla. And I think it's good night, Blues.
No, definitely. That's her fifth foul, 26 points. Another awesome performance by Kayla. Again, those two early fouls probably really hurt the Lady Blues. I think she was probably on target for a 35-40 point game if she was able to stay out there, and probably that biggest play in the game might have been subbing her out with 8 minutes to go and not being able to get her back in till the 4 minute mark. That 4 minute stretch where the MVP of the league potentially is sitting on the bench really hurt the Blues.
An unfortunate whistle on her for a fourth foul. She collected the offensive rebound, but it's done now. She goes to the bench with 26 points, 7 rebounds, 2 assists. You certainly can't point the finger at Kayla Standish for where the scoreboard's.
No, she leaves it all out on the floor and always plays hard, and probably just a little bit too late, the Blues, with their run, and in a little bit of trouble now. So 10-point margin, I guess the only thing that they can do is try and get some early traps and hope for a turnover and quick transition. Otherwise, maybe trying some fouling and see whether they can miss a couple of free throws and go from there. So I'd probably be putting Natalie B. Allen. I'd probably almost put in someone like Hollingsworth, who can really get out and defend, and potentially someone that can, at this stage, we're going to need 3 balls, so not sure if Natalie's going to be able to fire away.
The other question is, who do you foul? Claire Papavs with just 5 points tonight. She does have 9 boards and 5 assists. She's contributed, but is she the player you put to the line, given she hasn't had many shots?
Potential. I think at this stage, it's probably whoever catches it first. I don't think the Blues have probably got time to think, and good foul. She probably needs to step out behind the 3-point line.
Yeah, I think so. She had an outstanding first half, Bree Watman. She's been quieter here, but other players have stepped up. She's just played her role, and she's got 15 for the night. And now the Blues have to produce a miracle. Phillips pulls up. Oh, what a tough shot from Tenaya Phillips. She moves up to 17.
Good trap, good trap. Team. Now they need to foul.
Here is Papavs.
Good foul.
She's fouled by Jeffs. A wry smile from Meg Jeffs. Just her third for the game.
So they've just got to be smart and try and take a couple of gambles and see if they can get a steal in the backcourt. As soon as it gets in their half court, first person, get a quick foul.
Just quickly looking at the game of Meg Jeffs, early in the season and last season she had trouble with fouls. Tonight she's been able to play big minutes with just 3 fouls. Is that part of her maturation as a player?
Well, I think so, but just picked up her fifth now, as she had to foul late in the game. So I think she had a pretty good game. She was definitely at it defensively and was aggressive on the offensive end, but I mean, she definitely is developing every week as a player. The veteran Pappas knocks down 2.
So it didn't matter that she hadn't had a shot for a long time. She makes them both. It's been a solid night for her. An all-around contribution as the Blues try and they need to get a quick shot up. Here she is right up in the grill of Bowen. And she's fouled. It'll be a sideline ball for the Blues. And just looking at Papavs again, 7 points, 9 rebounds, 5 assists, 2 block shots and a steal.
Yeah, she's just that veteran player that knows how to play, and if she's not having a big scoring night, she can get others involved.
And she's played some outstanding defense too. Phillips with the O board, fades on the left hand and scores. That's her second pretty handy game in a row for Tenaya Phillips as the Blues try and steal, and Watman's fouled by Fiamingo. She'll shoot 2 more. So we look at the Blues' performance tonight. How do you rate it? It hasn't been consistent. There's been some good parts and bad parts. What's your take on it?
Well, I think it's just the ability to to play 40 minutes of defense. They've never had a problem scoring the ball, as Zoe Craig, one of our under 18 junior girls, subs in for her first action of SEABL basketball, which is fantastic to see Zoe out there. But they just can't defend for long enough at the moment. So that's where they're at. I think offensively they've got no problems and they can score in their sleep, but the ability to stay focused and defend for all 40 minutes is something that they've got to get better at.
Wattman makes the second free throw. Fiamenko with a nice pass outside. Long range bomb is off the mark there for... it's going to be a bruise ball. It's Torrey Jackson who fired that one up from the corner. And finally we see a sub from the Rangers.
I'm not sure how much you'd like being a junior player on this SEABL roster for Dandenong. You definitely don't get to see too much court time. So
Keely Patterson and Amy Baum into the game for the last 6.6 seconds. That pass off the mark. Bibby almost comes up with it. She can't. Last chance for Bialan to get one up. She drives strong, and referees say we're not going to give some free throws with 1 second on the clock, and that is full time. And there were some impressive moments from the Frankston Blues, but overall, Steve, that was an impressive display from Dandenong.
Yeah, just a little bit too smart, and the ability to make big plays when it really counted. Frankston made their runs in the last quarter, but Chloe Bibby was able to make some big plays, and that's what I guess happens with a team like Dandenong that are a little similar to Geelong, that a lot of them have played together for quite a while and are able to come up with big plays when needed. And you know, it's a tough loss for the Lady Blues. I know they were really trying to get this one and get back above 500. It puts them back to 2-3 with a really tough road trip to Tasmania next week, with both Tasmania teams doing a really good job so far in this early season. So you know, they're gonna have to go down there to Tassie now and win both and really get their season rolling.
Amy Clydesdale was the star for Dandenong. She had 28 points, 7 assists, 4 rebounds. She had a steal as well. She was everywhere tonight. She had so much support. Chloe Bibby, 19 points and 3 boards. She was outstanding, particularly in the second half. Bree Wattman with 16. Lauren Scherf, 16 points and 10 rebounds. In fact, she had 13 rebounds and 2 assists in there. And for Frankston, well, Callie Bowen, her numbers were outstanding. 22 points, 16 rebounds, 5 assists. She tried her heart out tonight, as did Kayla Standish with 26 points, 7 boards and 2 assists. She was 10 of 21 from the field. And Frankston shot at a good clip of 45%. It was the defensive end where they came up short. Tenaya Phillips, 19 points as well, but no other Frankston Blue with more than 5 points. And while Dandenong didn't sub a lot, they had 5 extremely good contributors.
Yeah, and we've been saying the same thing all year, that Phillips, Standish and Bowen can't get it done by themselves, and we really need some offensive contributions from others, and unfortunately haven't been able to get it done tonight. But even having said that, I think if they lock in and play defense, those big three are good enough to get them some wins. But you know, the ability not to lose concentration in crucial plays and give up easier layups or some three-point shots without a hand up at crucial times really hurt the Blues.
Final score was 89-79. It was a highly entertaining game, even though the crowd is a little disappointed at the final result. So Dandenong take the first game in this Anzac Day doubleheader. We've got 19 minutes until tip-off in the men's game. I hope you join us. A huge game for two teams who are both on 1 win and 3 losses. We'll see you then.
They don't even know where to go. Won't see me do no complaining. Maybe some rearranging. Now let's get this understood. Sometimes some change could be good. Could be good, could be great. Your destiny or your fate. If I wouldn't have get a profit, I'd still be moving the weight. Yeah, you know when I'm winning, you see me out and I'm grinning. Been chasing paper since Monday, that's 7 days I've been sinning. Count your yes, and some blessings. Cause they all got giving, I guess the big.
I've been waiting on this for some time. Now that it's here.
right hand, you my go-to. Told me everything about you, that's a bold move. I know that you're out here, and there's things you gotta go through. Just know that these streets just don't love you like I do. Yeah. And they never will, but I swear you gotta chill. You wanna grip a man's will, and I know you can't wait. You dream big and sleep late, you got a lot on your plate. That's why you're always working, taking pictures of yourself. You don't see anybody else, and your life, oh well. Your life, oh well. My past behind me like a ponytail, but you're my right hand, you're my go-to. Told me everything about you, that's a bold move. I know that you're out here, and there's things you gotta go through, yeah. Just know that these streets just don't love you like I do, yeah. And they never will. Okay, I know you want the Audi, I know you wanna go to Maui. You and all your girlfriends, the ones you never bring around me, cause you don't trust me like your last man. Did he open doors for you? Buy the things you can't afford for you? Cause he must've did a lot for you. I just fell back with it, and now your past is behind you like the car with the strap in it. Thank God that's finished. Cause now it's back to business. Any more Henny and you're past the limit. You told me about the picture, now you half the Senate. I would never put you on blast when I get it. You're my right hand, you're my go-to. Told me everything about you, that's a bold move. I know that you're out here, and there's things you gotta go through, yeah. Just know that these streets just don't love you like I do, and they never will. You my right hand, you my go-to. Told me everything about you, that's a bold move. I know that you're out here, and there's things you gotta go through. Just know that these streets just don't love you like I do, yeah. And they never will.
So I hit her in the DM. All eyes, yeah, I see him. Yeah, this your man, I hate to be him. It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down. It go down.
It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down.
I tell
him down.
Snapchat me that move. On FaceTime me that if it's cool. Boy, my DM poppin'. My DM just caught a body.
Move.
I got celebs in the DM.
Ooh.
They're breaking news if they see them.
Ooh.
But nah, we don't do no talkin'.
We don't do no talkin'.
We see suckers too often. I seen your girl post a DM. So I hit her in the DM. All eyes, yeah, I see him. Yeah, this your man, I hate to be him. It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down. It go down.
It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down.
I tell
it go down.
Don't you hate when you get screenshotted?
Petty.
That DM one for everybody.
Rules.
I love the gram. I love the gram.
I love the gram.
I'm addicted to it. I know I am.
I know I am.
And I just follow Angela
Simmons.
I got a crush on Angela
Simmons.
They like to got it, you bold.
Bold.
Kid, I'm gon' let the world know.
Goes.
I seen your girl post a DM. So I hit her in the DM. All eyes, yeah, I see him. Yeah, this your man, I hate to be him.
Whoa.
Snapchat me that. Snapchat me that. If it's cool.
Snapchat me that.
Snapchat me that. If it's cool.
I seen your girl post a BM. So I hit her in the DM. All eyes, yeah, I see him. Yeah, this your man, I hate to be him. It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down. It go down.
It goes down in the DM.
It go down.
It go down in the DM.
It go down. It go down.
Religious, you know, I always been by my paper, yeah, greatness, you know, hard work, YFMBC thinks a game, it's not a game, hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. I can't see nobody stopping us, yeah. We're unstoppable. Went through a whole lot of obstacles. I swear we did the impossible. Run all that paper and then f*** it up. Go hit the club and then f*** it up. A whole lot of pain, we gon' get it back. You know we gon' get it back. I can't see nobody stopping us. Unstoppable, unstoppable, unstoppable. Run all that paper and then get it. Whatever it take, we gon' get it. You know ain't nobody stopping us. Mafia, mafia, mafia. All of my n***a, they mafia. Thought I told you we unstoppable. I just spent a brick on my Jesus. You gotta put God first. I swear I turned to believers. This shit came from hard work. Gotta hustle, stay down with your people. Can't betray the one who feeds you. No competition, we are equal. Can't let nobody mislead you. The Ray Ray from Summer Hill. It's only one of him. Sue Atlanta, number Lions Hill. We was raised not to have a fear. When nothing dies, there's so many tears. So many nights I cried and cried and swore. So many nights I cried and cried, I swear. All of these lying. Photo ready but without the frame. Just spend a quarter on my wrist and chain. If you get caught, you better not mention name. Blowing more smoke than a train. That red be keeping me sane. Unstoppable, I am untamed. I am unstoppable just like the train, hey. I can't see nobody stopping us, yeah. We're unstoppable. Went through a whole lot of obstacles. I swear we did the impossible. Run on that paper and then f*** it up. Go hit the club and then f*** it up. A whole lot of pain, we gon' get it back. You know we gon' get it back. I can't see nobody stopping us. Unstoppable, unstoppable, unstoppable. Run on that paper and then get it. Whatever it take, we gon' get it. You know ain't nobody stopping us. Mafia, mafia, mafia. All of my n***a, they mafia. Thought I told you we unstoppable. I can't see nobody stopping us. Mafia, mafia, mafia. I can't see nobody. All of the money swallowed. The money keep blocking them. So all of the hunters, I die for them. You know all of my partners, I die for them. Fuck around and spend a block with them. So I only hang with them shotters. Yeah, so you know we came with them choppers. Yeah, remember them day we had Nauta. I ain't never pouring a drink and we popping champagne. It is what it is, I can't. You lame, yeah, yeah. The power, the money, the Carter. Bang. Vow to all my dogs, I never change. Get that real mafia shit. Put some little guap on your clip. Add a little 30 on top and they top your shit. You know I'm on top of my shit. Gotta show him what unstoppable is. Sorry, Lord, but a killer be killed. For switch, then that's on him. Can't let no boo NFL. I can't see nobody stopping us. We unstoppable. Went through a whole lot of obstacles. I swear we did the impossible. Run on that paper and then f*** it up. Go hit the club and then f*** it up. A whole lot of pain, we gon' get it back. You know we gon' get it back. I can't see nobody stopping us. Unstoppable, unstoppable, unstoppable. Run on that paper and then get it. Whatever it take, we gon' get it. You know ain't nobody stopping us. Mafia, mafia, mafia. All of my n***a, they mafia. Thought I told you we unstoppable.
Thank you.
it sound like some 4301. All my wanna do is pop style. Turn my birthday into a lifestyle. Tell my mom I love her if I do not make it. Got so many chain, they call me Chain and Tatum. And I like to finish what you think you started. Man, you boy just got to Hollywood, you boy just started. You don't know what you just started. All I do is hang with the young and heartless. All is for my family, man, I try my hardest. It's all I ever did, and look where it got him. Yeah, you been on my mind lately. You still got my number, girl, you need to call me. I feel like they wanna see me learn the hard way. But you know I always handle that one my way. Girl, let me rock, 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 rock your body. Justin Timberlake and then I hit the highway. I can't trust nobody. They still out to get me, cause they never got me.
They still out to get me, they don't get it. I cannot be gotten, that's a given.
They like Pablo. Why are all the windows tinted on your Tahoe? Why do you know every single that I know? Why can't you just shut your mouth and take the high road? If I know, that's that Chicago. South, south, side, that's the motto. Cop a crib and spend 10 million on remodel. Take the devils out my life and preach the gospel. Cause I know we went way, way past the line of scrimmage, ayy. Throwing his back up in it, ayy. In the field like M&A. Y'all get so offended, ayy. I be blacking out, I ain't backing out. Jay about his business, and I'ma let you finish, but I just wanna rock your body. Take you to the garage and do some karate. Chop it, chop it, chop it, chop it, sippin' sake. Throw a thing on a Kawasaki.
Dropped out of school, now we dumb rich. This sound like some 4301. All my wanna do is pop style. Turn my birthday into a lifestyle.
Both teams to the benches, please. Ladies and gentlemen, if we could have your attention, please. We'd like to throw over to High Performance Manager Steve Blackley, who'll say a few words this evening.
Welcome, everybody, to tonight's big game between Frankston and Dandenong. The Frankston Basketball Association would like to acknowledge the passing of Linda Perry yesterday afternoon. Linda was a longtime president of the Bowen Basketball Club, and a very important person in the basketball community. Our thoughts are with Linda and her family. Shout out to Darren and Jack, who are Darren's coaching tonight, and Jack's part of the Rangers team. Our thoughts are with you guys. So best of luck. Thank you.
So ladies and gentlemen, it's time to welcome you here to Frankston. Welcome you to our house for SEABL Basketball of the 2016 Championship Series. Tonight we've opened the doors to the Dandenong Rangers, a team who, like us, are searching for their second win of the season. And with a full house in the stands tonight, there's no excuse not to get behind your Frankston Blues. Let's now give a warm welcome to the Rangers squad for tonight. They start with number one, Liam Gibkiss. Number two, Daquan Montreal. Number three, Jordan Jacatine. Number five, Juice Biondolo. Number six, Matt Owies. Number eight, Mason Peatling. Number nine, Jack Saunders. Number 12, Lucas Walker. Number 14, Chuck Long. Number 21, Gabe Hadley. Number 32, Owen Onagy. And number 34, Andrew Harms. The head coach of the Rangers is Darren Perry. And now Frankston, you know what time it is. It's time to get that energy up as we meet the home team. Number two, Jake McCauley. Number five, Mike McInnes. Number nine, Corey Maynard. Number 10, Harry Chevely. Number 11, Dane Switala. Number 14, Tom Wilson. Number 15, Josh Oswald. Number 22, Benny Lewis III. Number 33, Jack Wilson. And number 45, Matt Turner. The head coach of your Blues is Grant Wallace, assisted by Ricky Baldwin and Julie Mate. The team manager is Paul Groats. We now invite our Frankston ladies team to come out and join the men for our ANZAC Day presentations. The Frankston RSL, of course, are proud sponsors of your Frankston Blues. We'd like to welcome out Kevin Hillier and Rob Morrison for the ANZAC Day Oath.
Thank you very much. Please join with me as we reflect on the memory of our fallen and departed comrades from all conflicts throughout the world, although very little has occurred on our own soil. I'd ask you all to please be upstanding. They have no grave but the cruel sea. No flowers lay at their heads. A rusting hulk is their tombstone, afast on the ocean bed. They went with songs to battle. They were young, straight of limb, true of eye, steady and aglow. They were staunch to the end, against odds uncounted. They fell with their faces to the foe. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Lest we forget. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
We now ask that with all people upstanding, you please stay on your feet for the Australian National Anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got 5 minutes until to tip off here in Frankston. It's the Blues taking on the Dandenong Rangers.
Check the check, do the math, I ain't never getting robbed. Those margaritas not going on my card. I ain't about to split a damn thing for convenience sake. I'm at the restaurant working that way taller. You ain't heard a little day, young elder, Jew, biz major. You know about the world he raised in. I've been saving money since a mother 13. I wear the same pair of jeans every day. Free sandwiches, homie, 2 stamps away. Book flight December, but I leave in May. Drugs are generic, but still work the same. I get logins for Netflix for my cousin Greg. Thanks, Greg. I disregard them. All of them that can hold it, ain't got no God in them. I can teach a little son like a preacher. I can take his up to church fresh as hell, no east. I can make his burp like a baby without no hiccup. I can
Quan, what does this have to do with saving money though? You know what, a full verse would have been too expensive anyway.
Trap. I ain't parking at unless to meet a green, homie. Haircut several months in between, homie. Hit the mop lights when I leave, homie. Single ply TP, bleed Airbnb, the motherfucking lease. I'm never there. I'm out in Cali, why the fuck my company in Delaware? And happy hour taking out a chicken. I don't even care. Now the plots to both dating and wings. Keep matinees, phone bill, got the motherfucking fam on it. 401k rolling over bands on it. Copper sweaters in the summer when the sale over. Hot. You rappers brag about you overpaying for it. Low threat count, hard with the covers. Woo! Free trial memberships, doubt. Hey. I never joined this shit, doubt. Hey. You think this is doubt? Free been flying like a mother fish, though. General style, half a dozen on a stick, just so I can whet the appetite a bit. What you talking about? My AC never doing nothing, blow fans. Walgreens, car shopping, all the off brands. Boy, go hard when collecting, got Vim. Save a month, roach, try and smoke. Check the clothes in my drawers, I ain't playing around. It's LD, little boy, Mr. Hand me down. My dirty drawers getting worn, can you blame me now? You think I got 450 up in corners on me while I'm fucking dope?
Yeah, baby. if you're at a restaurant. You get your bitch and Billy, you can see double charging for the coffee. And you told him there's a problem, sing along like, oh, don't double charge me for that. Don't double charge me, we like, oh, don't double charge me for that. Don't do it to yourself, cause I might just ask what the ice cube's worth. What the ice cube's worth.
It's ANZAC Day at the Frankston Basketball Stadium, and that means only one thing. The Frankston Blues and the Dandenong Rangers going head to head, and there is an intensity in this building that you can feel. I'm Paulo Kennedy. I'm joined by Steve Blackley. This is going to be an outstanding game. Of course, the big move during the week, Steve, Ishmael Hollis sent home by the Blues, Townsville Crocs point guard Corey Maynard into the Frankston lineup. What difference is that going to make?
Well, yeah, the Blues probably had the two best trainings for the year. We probably get a genuine point guard and an on-court leader that defends and can really control the team. So really looking forward to the impact that Corey will have on this group. And I think he's one of those players that makes everyone else around him play better. And probably couldn't be better timing ahead of the big game with the Rangers.
Of course, the other storyline of this game is a couple of Frankston champions playing for the Rangers now, Andrew Harms and Chuck Long. Is there always that little bit of extra feeling with those two back in the building?
Always is, but Harms is a legend of this club and got the text message during the day for some free tickets at the door, which we looked after him, and great family of the Frankston club. And Chuck was a long time import here as well, so quality game, a lot of NBL talent on the floor. Really looking forward to this one.
And it's won by Dandenong. Owen Odigi wins, or retrieves the trap. He gives it to Harms, and we're underway. The crowd is already pumping in this one. Here is Odigi to the low, and he jams it down with a right hand. Owen Odigi gets upstairs to get us started. Montreal with the steal. Drives. Oh, what a finish around Swatella, and it's in the blink of an eye, it's 4-0 to Dandenong. Well,
costly turnover by Swatella, resulting in a layup to the reigning MVP, Daquan Montreal.
How about the energy of Dandenong early as Lewis tries to settle the nerves? It's short. Odigi with the rebound. Wilson harassing him, almost pinches it. It'll be a Dandenong ball.
Well, the Rangers have come to play, four early points, and they are huge across the line.
Big, strong men, of course. Lucas Walker, Daquan Montreal, I should say. Liam in the power forward spot as we see Montreal now for three, hits it. What a start for Dandenong, 7-0. Daquan Montreal with the triple.
You just can't give him that sort of space. He's way too good to let have room to set up and get his shot off.
Here's Maynard. Oswald for three, he can't hit it. And the Blues almost look a little bit shell-shocked by the intensity Dandenong's brought. Harms inside, Maynard will pinch it. Now in the open court, Lewis on the break. Maynard goes straight at Walker, he's white. Montreal recovers, Odigi with the ball. Dandenong, they're a team possessed at the moment. But Andrew Harms said, come on boys, let's pull this one out. 7-0 after 100 seconds of play. Harms to the left hand and he finishes. I wonder if Grant Wallace is thinking about a timeout already.
Well, it's one of those ones. I don't think an early timeout's going to make much of a difference. They need to dig down and play some defense here.
Walker with the rebound. He's pushing in transition. Good defense from Benny Lewis.
And Walker picked up two early fouls in last night's game against Mount Gambier and had to sit. So good possession there by Benny Lewis.
The Rangers well beaten by Mount Gambier last night. At home, they're 1-3 after four games
yep.
at home.
So this is a huge game for both clubs. No one wants to go 1-4, so a lot riding on this one.
Here's Swatella with his first opportunity. He cans it, and that'll just settle the nerves of the crowd, the players, the coaches. It's 9-2.
Good start for Swatella. We need him operating out of that low block. You can't give Montreal space. That's just going to be money all game. Probably got away with one.
Dodges a bullet. Maynard decides to pull it out. He wants to run a set. He's got Switala. He drives around Gibkus.
Good
nice
pass.
Feed. Lewis for three. It's good. And the Blues are starting to roll.
You can see already Maynard runs this team. Happy to pull it out and run a set and get the ball through good hands.
Great composure there. Didn't explore too much in transition. He knew where he could get a teammate a good shot. Odigi to the line. To the lane. Finds Gibkus inside. And the rotation was a little slow. So 11-5. Maynard again working off the ball screen. This time he goes himself, a little short. And Dandenong looking to run at every opportunity. Here's Montreal feeds, Gibkus inside. And now Grant Wallace does reach into the timeout kit bag. It's 13-5 after 3.5 minutes. And it's Anzac Day, it's the traditional battle, and it means a lot to Dandenong, you can see that.
Well, interesting that the Blues have come out a little similar to what the Lady Blues were, with just not getting it done on the defensive end. 13 early points, I think they're almost, I think they're perfect from the field already. Most of them being one three, and the rest have been layups pretty much. So really got to buckle down and defend, and maybe the big crowd and the big ceremony for Anzac Day has spooked the Blues a little bit. So game's only early, only a couple of baskets here or there, and the game tightens up and the Rangers under a little bit of pressure, but got to get it done at the defensive end.
I think the difference between the two teams is Dandenong defensively are disruptive, getting up and in, whereas Frankston have been falling back and perhaps allowing Dandenong to run their sets a little bit too easily.
Yeah, you'll see the Rangers will switch everything. They'll switch on balls. They're all kind of 6'4 and above. Their bigs can guard the perimeter players, so pretty disruptive on the defensive end being able to do that.
Dacon Montreal with 5 points to start with. Gibkus with four on a couple of brilliant feeds inside just to finish.
Yeah, really unselfish play from the Rangers so far. And the Rangers go to the bench early, bringing in Chuck Long and Matt Owies. So Coach Perry is one of those coaches that likes to rotate and keep fresh bodies on. Whether you're up or down, you won't know. He'll coach the same.
Yeah, Chuck Long, a legend of this competition. And Matt Owies, one of the young up-and-coming players. He represented Australia at the Under-17 World Championships a couple of years ago. Here's Oswald taking it inside. That's a tough
move. There we go. Good take.
13-7. So the Blues have weathered the storm a little bit. Here is Owies to the basket. That's a tough finish on the left hand.
Everything's just in the charge circle. They're getting into the lane at will at the moment.
Here is Switala.
Swing the ball.
Benny Lewis wanting to go at Chuck Long. Now Wilson with his first shot of the night. That's good. And you can't help but feel the Blues have weathered a bit of a storm here.
Yep. A couple of big shots and they're back in the game.
15-10. There's been a little bit of a Daquan Montreal storm as well. He's been
good
aggressive.
Job, Tommy Wilson.
He picked the pocket. Two athletes to go at. He's fouled by Chuck Long. There'll be two free throws to come.
Tommy probably playing a little bit of a different role now with Maynard into the lineup. Can play at that two spot a little bit, which I think will suit him. He'll still spend some time at the one, but having two guys on in the backcourt that can really control the ball is a real bonus for the Blues.
And we've seen him so far tonight, three occasions just sweating on steals. There's a little bit of Ricky Rubio about the way he goes about it.
Probably built a little bit like Ricky, those long arms and legs, and great to see him get off to a nice, good start.
He's hit a three-pointer already. Makes his first free throw. So just a four-point ball game. The same thing happened last week with the Geelong Supercats. They led 10-2 after 2 minutes, but the Blues were able to steady.
Big crowd in here tonight. Fantastic atmosphere at the House of Blues.
As we see Daquan Montreal knocking that one off the rim.
Little full court pressure here.
Here is Montreal driving strong at Switala and finishing. He says, what about the foul? But I say, what about that finish? And he is a high quality player at this level, isn't he, Steve?
Yeah, best American in the SEABL. So an all-star every year he's been out here and becoming an Australian citizen shortly too. So look at him to get back into that NBL once that happens.
7 points already for DQ. Here's Oswald inside.
Good pass, Benny
Lewis.
What a
beautiful feed. So the Blues have settled, and just like the women's game, this is an absolute shootout. 30 points in the first 5 minutes. They go to Montreal again. Why wouldn't you? He pulls up, but that one's long. And Oswald inside. Gee, he's been a valuable pickup for the Blues.
He has been. And I think with Ishmael not with us anymore, I think you'll see Oswald get some more touches.
Wilson,
as Wilson from downtown. And here they come.
He brings the crowd to life. And all of a sudden, it's just a one-point ball game. Tom Wilson with six.
Fantastic fight back.
His arms. He's looked dangerous early. This time he finds Montreal. That's a layup for him, but some good defense from Lewis. Here's Wilson, where he's best. Lewis somehow keeps it alive, and Maynard will calm things down. Shot clock at 12. Wilson's feeling good.
Hey, Wilson for three again.
Tom Wilson up to 10 points already in the game after just 6 minutes. And Rangers coach Darren Perry takes a timeout with his team trailing 17-19.
A little by story on Tom Wilson. There's a little bit of bad blood between Tommy and the Dandenong Rangers when he was with the under 20 state team about 6 or 8 weeks ago. They had a practice game and got into it a little bit. So I know he's been fired up and looking forward to this game. He's had this marked on the calendar, and you can tell by the way he's come out, he's got real purpose to this game.
Well, it's a 14-4 run for the Blues in the past 3 minutes of this game. And a lot of it's been about Tom Wilson. He's another man who's represented the Australian junior team at international level. And he was a quality player at that level too.
He really was. Where would you rather be on a Sunday night? The House of Blues with national and American imports lighting up the gym. Fantastic atmosphere. I think we're in for a cracking game.
36 points in 6 minutes of play so far. And you can just feel the crowd buzzing around this stadium. There's probably 500 or 600 people packed in here tonight.
You know, you're in for a big crowd when both sides of the bleachers are filled up and all the corporate boxes are full. We've had people calling up, requesting tickets and trying to pre-order. So probably our biggest night on the calendar.
Well, it hasn't let us down so far. It was all Dandenong early. It's been all Frankston the past 3 minutes. And now we've got a ball game as Jack White into the ball game and playing some excellent defense there. Walker strong to the basket.
Oh.
And a foul called on Benny Lewis.
Not sure how he called that one, seeing that from a long way away. It's probably the wrong official to make that call.
So Walker will go to the stripe as Owen Ottergy comes into the ball game for Matt Owey. So again, the Rangers going back to that big lineup. Expect to see them start switching and being disruptive again defensively.
So Frankston onto their bench as well with Jake McCauley and Jack Wilson coming in. So they big contributions off them tonight.
And we saw Jake McCauley hit a couple of threes last week against Sandringham and get into this season for the first time. Let's see if he can have a contribution tonight. He's defended by Andrew Harms. Wilson strong.
Great pass to his brother.
It's Tom White to Jack White, but Jack couldn't finish. Sorry, Jack Wilson, I should say. And there's a steal.
Here they go.
Defense from Jack Wilson. Here's Tom, and deflected away by Lucas Walker. And I'll have to apologize to the Wilson family. I got a little excited there and turned them into Whites.
We could do with a couple of Whites as well, I imagine.
There's Tom Wilson.
Good pass.
He's fouled.
And that's two on Walker. That's huge. Same story as last night. He picks up a second foul. We won't see him until the second half now. DP's a watches his fouls pretty tightly, and they're a deep roster, so Walker will have to cool his jets till the second half.
He was just a split second late on that rotation, but you talk about the importance of that. In this fixture last season, he had 8 points but 17 rebounds. Such a dominant figure on the glass when he's up and about.
Yeah, one of the premier athletes in all of Australian basketball at the moment, in the Boomer squad as well for the upcoming Olympics, so doing great things.
Swatella at the stripe, he's got three tonight, he's got four, and that's the Blues lead. It was just 4 minutes ago, they trailed by eight. See Harms guarded by McCauley. Here's Peatling guarded by Jack Wilson. J Jack Wilson commits the foul. There's a little bit of a height mismatch in that spot.
Yeah, Harms, he's got some good size as a point guard, and we'll look to exploit that matchup and get him in the post if he can.
Maynard back into the ball game for Tom Wilson. I'm sure Grant Wallace will be a lot happier with his three-guard rotation now with Maynard in. He can rotate McCauley, Wilson and Maynard in and out.
Well, something you notice already is, and we notice at practice already, with the addition of Maynard, is the ball starts moving and doesn't stick as much.
Here's Montreal flashing to the low post. Odigi finds him, bangs inside. It's off the mark. And Maynard comes up with the board. Here's McCauley. 2:45 to run until quarter time. Swatella from long range is a little bit long.
Probably not the shot they need just yet. That'll come later in the game. Get down low and...
One thing Dandenong appeared to have identified is Jack Wilson. They're going in at whoever he's guarding. That time, Peatling is off the mark with his left-hand hook.
They really are attacking, and Swatella doing a great job on the boards. Great pass! Maynard!
Back
there
pass.
We go!
He finds Jack Wilson underneath for the easiest of two-pointers, and the Blues lead it by six. That's the pass of the season so far. Harms inside to the left-hand. His second classy left-hand finish.
Look at that pass!
Benny Lewis picks up the loose ball, casually hooks it in with a right hand. What a ball game we've got.
We are in for a treat, ladies and gentlemen, tonight. It's deep. One hell of a game.
Harms to Odigi. He just slows it down a little bit. Here's DQ.
Got to get a hand up on that.
That one's short. Oh, Peatling inside. And again, that power forward position where the Blues are a little undersized.
Yep.
And perhaps we'll see Josh Oswald back in the game pretty soon.
Peatling, one of the bright talents in Australian basketball, off to the University of Eastern Washington come this August, and they look for big things for him in the future.
McCauley, he hit two threes last week. He starts off with a triple. I promised him if he hit one, I'd give the three-point sign, so I'm doing it.
And
the Blues lead
it
by
seven. He's probably lucky he made that shot, because I know Grant Wallace was imploring him to get the ball into the low block, so Odigi. Good job getting that shot in.
Oh, some good man-on-man defense from both Swatella and Maynard, but Montreal just too good. He finishes inside. He's up to 9 points for the game, but it's the Blues leading by five. 50 seconds to play.
Now back him in.
Swatella against Montreal. They'd love a couple of fouls on him, the Blues.
There we go.
Soft touch inside.
And I think with the changeover from Hollis to Maynard, I think you're going to see some big improvement from Swatella. There'll be more ball movement, more looks for him. So fantastic start for him in this game.
Harms finds long inside again to Peatling.
How long in the key?
Now Odigi wide open for three, but that's not his game. And McCauley's away in the open floor.
One shot, pulled out for one shot here.
Oh, hand in there from Peatling. We've got some substitutions coming. No surprise, Mike McInnes into the ball game for the final shot. Just to spread the floor, let's look for him in the corners.
Keep the defense honest. Look for a little pick and roll action here with Maynard, maybe a horn set with Swatella and Lewis.
I'd love to see a pick and pop from Benny Lewis.
Yep.
He's pretty dangerous in that situation. So 10 seconds on the clock, Maynard against Odigi. A couple of NBL talents going at it there. Maynard with the crossover and he's fouled. That's the fourth foul on Dandenong, so they'll be happy with that one. 3:03 on the clock. What do you go to here?
Maybe a pin down screen or something for Lewis with that quick release. Maynard will look to Maynard to throw the ball in. Such a good decision maker. Plenty of time to go off the dribble as well with 3:03 to go.
Look for McInnes as well. He's a dangerous proposition. And perhaps Swatella diving to the hoop. Just got a little sweat on the floor at the moment. We have a pause, and for once so far in this game, the crowd actually silent. There's been so much to cheer about. 53 points so far in this quarter, and still one attempt to come.
He's going to come through the picket fit. Oh, there it is, the alley-oop!
Oh,
that was
In fact, we caught a violation, so there'll be one last opportunity for Dandenong. It was a beautifully crafted play.
Yeah, just the ball went to the wrong side of the ring. The play was on. There was
Here's DQ. He's hit a few tough shots already tonight, but That one was a little beyond him, and after 10 pulsating minutes of SEABL basketball, it's Frankston 30 leading Dandenong 23. Tell us all about that quarter, Steve.
Probably the quarter of the season for the Blues, being in a hole early and really been under the pump, but bounced back to finish with 30 points in the quarter. The ball moved, they had some fast break action, they knocked down some threes, they got it down to Swatella down low. Just a fantastic game from both teams so far. So for the viewers at home, don't go anywhere. I think you're in for a treat for the next three quarters. So the big guns have all turned up tonight.
Tom Wilson with 10 points for the Blues. Dane Swatella with 6. Benny Lewis with 5. Corey Maynard hasn't been on fire scoring-wise, but already 3 rebounds and 2 assists for the Blues' newest recruit. And for Dandenong, Montreal with 9. And after that, it's Harms and Gibkiss with 4 each in terms of the boards. Peatling with 2, Ottergy 2, Harms 2, and Montreal 2. So they have been spreading the load there. It's been an outstanding first quarter, as I've said. Steve, I mean, if you're the Blues coaching staff, is there anything you change after that first 10 minutes?
No, I think they really bounced back well. They got good contributions off the bench, which was important. No one's in foul trouble. Really good balanced scoring. Obviously, Tommy exploded for 3 quick triples, so I'll be looking to get him back into the game pretty soon. But you can already see the addition of Maynard is going to bring a lot of energy to this team, and I think we automatically become a better defensive team with Corey because he's a dogged defender at that guard position. And I just love the way that they're moving the ball, really unselfish basketball. I think Benny and Dane and Oswald are all going to get more looks now that that Maynard's on the team.
I think one thing that's also been noticeable with Maynard is his ability to read that ball screen situation. We've seen him split the defense a couple of times and then kick the ball on. And, of course, that behind-the-back pass to Jack Wilson was just sublime.
Yeah, really crafty. Probably doesn't have blistering pace, but just knows how to get through gaps and crafty with both hands. And he's got a beautiful shot fake on his layup. He'll get into the charge circle and fake with the right hand and finish with the left. We haven't seen that yet, but I think someone that's attacking probably, and the team did miss someone that was good at getting to the basket and drawing defenders. So Coach Wallace will be rapt with his output. Although his stats haven't been outstanding to start with, he's definitely had an impact on the style of play that the Blues are running.
I think the other important statistic for the Blues, Dane Swatella, 6 points, no fouls.
And cleaning up on the glass as well.
In terms of Dandenong, their defensive pressure early was outstanding. It really troubled the Blues. I wonder if we'll see them go back to that. Here's Montreal against Gibkiss. He bangs into him and fades away.
I like that shot. Attack down low and make him defend you on the low block.
It's been a quality game of basketball so far. Here's Gibkiss against Oswald. Lucas Walker along the baseline and he tucks it in. And nice execution again from Dandenong, and they draw back within 5.
Yeah, Lewis went for that steal and was made to pay.
A little bit of pressure defense from Dandenong, but Frankston navigate their way through that. Shot clock at 11, Lewis against Walker, former teammates at Melbourne, and Benny Lewis slashes the 3 ball. He's up to 8 points for the game, and it's an 8-point lead. Ambitious pass inside. Montreal recovers. Walker from outside this time. He says, right back at you, Benny.
And they'll wear that one. They'll wear Walker shooting the 3. Interesting DP's gone with him on 2 fouls. So I think he knows they're in a little bit of trouble. So nice move, Josh. Oswald.
He just backed Ottergy in and finished with the left hand. Frankston looking like a different team this week to what we saw in the opening 2 home games here on Blues Basketball Media as Walker thinks about going again, drives to the floater. That's a tough shot. And Swatella on the glass. That's been called a travel. Not sure if it's the correct call because he didn't actually dribble the ball in the end. It went off Harm's leg, but
I think Benny may have told him the same thing.
But it's Dandenong ball, and that's all that matters. They've got a chance to just stem the flow here. Walker looking aggressive. They've gone away from DQ a little bit to open this second quarter, but Gibkiss with a tough move.
They've got multiple players that can post up and score out of the low block. They've just got great length and size.
Dane Swatella showing some handles there to get through the press.
Now get down to the low block, big fella.
As Maynard gets the ball moving to Lewis. This one's off the mark. Swatella got a hand on it, but Dandenong are away. Odigy to the basket. Rims around and out. And that's
offensive foul hole.
That's a terrible call from the official.
Was. He was underneath the basket. He really got away with one then.
Now that's one we've talked about a couple of times on the broadcast is for some reason in Australia, the referees will call those as offensive fouls. Around the world, it's called differently, and it's just something players have to adjust to. And unfortunately, as fans, we miss out on some of the high-flying action because of it.
A little 2-1-2 action, and they'll fall back into a man-to-man.
That's a tough pressing defense when you've got length like Walker, Odigy, and Montreal up
and that's
the front
of the
press.
They take up so much space with their... with their length, and it's more of a slowing down defense. It's not an attacking let's go and get steals, but just take time off the clock, and they've done it like that for many years.
As Benny Lewis throws that one away with an ambitious pass.
Blues need to settle down on the offensive land and stop taking some forced shots and some turnovers.
There's Montreal inside. He just elevates over Oswald and tucks it in, and Dandenong have started this quarter on a bit of a roll. 35-32, Frankston still lead.
You can feel that the game's kind of slowed down a little bit now. I'd like to see Maynard get involved offensively a little bit.
Excellent defense from Andrew Harms. That's an area of his game that he's worked on over the years and came up with a steal there.
And one of the veterans of the SEABL, and has always been rated as one of the best Australian point guards in the league, and a real luxury for the Rangers to have someone that experienced just anchor their offense year after year.
Yeah, and a player who can run the show, or he can step up and be a real scorer when needed to. There's Maynard with
good
the steal.
Defense.
He read the Harms pass like a cheap novel, and he lays it in, and that's just the steadying basket that Frankston needed. He's always into the game.
Nearly got another one.
Frankston actively looking to deny Montreal the ball as Walker pops open.
And again, happy for him to get that, happy for him to take that shot.
Oh, he's with the hustle after McKinnis saved it. Up goes Montreal, and he's fouled by Turner. And a referee
late
from the far side
the
caught
far
it.
Side again.
But I'm not sure that the truck could perhaps get up that high to block that one. So I'll give the referee the benefit of the doubt. A good defensive play from the big fella to make DQ earn it from the stripe.
Great sub here, getting Wilson back in to close out the second quarter.
I think the way that they're defending today, it's a real, especially after those first few minutes when they're a little bit shell-shocked, they've had that real active defense, you know, looking to get hands in, looking to help off other players to deny post feeds, and I think that style of game just suits Tom so well.
Yeah, no, for sure.
So Wilson and Maynard in the backcourt, going up against Harms and Owies, so some real quality there.
And here comes that 2-1-2. They like to put a guard at the back of that press and go with some size up at the front line.
Here is Wilson. Let's see if he attacks the press. He decides to run some offense this time. Still 16 left on the shot clock. Let's see what the Blues can run. Maynard just casually from the top. He's a little short.
Good look.
I noticed in the warm-up he was leaving things a little short as well. I think he's just still getting used to these rims, as Andrew Harms knows these rims pretty well. That one rims out. And
good decision. He nearly released that pass to Tommy, who saw him late, and they probably just need a steadying possession here.
So Maynard again. A little miscommunication between the two.
Yeah. And I think Maynard, I mean, his shooting stroke's probably going to come over the next couple of weeks as he gets some more practice time in. He was having some time off, and so hasn't been shooting a lot, but he can be valuable without shooting.
Just can't get that to go. Maynard says we're going to run some offense, and that's what he's been good at so far today, as we see a zone, little zone defense here. It's perhaps a switching matchup zone as Maynard finds Wilson. He's already hit three of them. Oh, that one
that
goes
good
in and
too.
Out. Benny Lewis with the hustle. And they'll reset. 10 on the shot clock for Maynard at the top. He doesn't need it. He goes, and this one's a little wide. Again, the hustle. Lewis to the pull-up. No, he defers to Oswald in the corner.
Third time! Three-ball Connor Pocket. He's missed his probably last six or seven three-point attempts from the weekend. That was a big shot for Josh.
He shot that with plenty of confidence.
Yeah. And really off to it. Josh has been off to a great start tonight.
Alley-oop to Lucas Walker upstairs. He does a chin-up. He does the double-handed backboard slap.
I'm surprised that wasn't a tech foul. I mean, the extra pull-up and the... Yeah, that was interesting. The backboard slap as well.
Well, he certainly gets some style points for that one. That's the best dunk celebration I've seen for a while from Lucas Walker. Steve Blackley not happy. He's got to pay for that rim if it gets broken.
He just placed him on there as well, so give him a good test.
Wilson,
oh, nice move! Still looking for him.
Tom Wilson faked the pass to the middle. That's the old Nick Van Exel move from the 1990s. I don't know if Tom even knows who Nick Van Exel is, but that was beautiful. Fires from range, and this game has gone up a level again. 3 points is the Frankston lead. What about some of the play at both ends?
This is just a high-level contest. Two really well-coached teams with a lot of talent on the floor, and Benny Lewis takes his first sub for the game. Expect Benny only to be up for a couple of minutes and get back in.
I like this, having Jack Wilson and Oswald on together as well. It makes it a little harder for Dandenong to go at Jack like they were in that first quarter. Zone defense again. Swatella surveys the options. Oh, Maynard with a tough
good
step back. And what a feed to Oswald. You'd think they'd been playing together for 5 years, not 5 minutes.
Fantastic pass. He really is a real court general.
44-39. I hope you are enjoying Blues basketball media tonight. It's
Look
the Anzac Day shootout.
Ball.
Here's Chuck Long inside. Finds Owies. Look at the closeout, but they leave DQ open for three, and he's long. And I think there's a foul on Jack Wilson on the rebound.
And Chuck may have over-exaggerated that one. Got called for a tech foul last night on flopping, so might have been a little exaggeration on that one.
He thought he'd test these referees out as well.
It's been a well-officiated game. Not many fouls called, and just letting the boys play.
Yeah, it's been physical. They've just called what they have to. Zone defense from the Blues. They're looking to go at DQ at Swatella. Good defense from Dane, but it takes more than that to stop Montreal.
Yeah, it was good defense, but better offense. Oh, bad pass.
And it's going to come off Wilson to the rim. Finishes with the left hand. What about how quickly he read that loose ball?
One end to the other. He was down in the backcourt as the pass got released and finished on the other end.
Well, Montreal's got 18. Wilson's got 14. It's the young and old of it coming to play here tonight. Into the corner. That's a long three-point attempt there from Gabe Hadley.
Oh, look at that. Looking to get to the basket here.
Maynard going it long. Pushes off. And got in the air. Didn't know where to go.
Uh-oh.
And stand by.
Oh! Big play.
Montreal fumbles it out of bounds. And I was about to say he's moving to 20 points. Perhaps he was thinking about what backboard slap he would do afterwards, and he spent it before he had it.
Now, a bit of a break there for the Blues, that's for sure. DQ still smiling there, so I'm sure that the Rangers teammates will be letting him know about that. That'll be a fine during the week for sure.
So 5 points, the Blues lead. Swatella again with the point guard duties, going against Chuck Long. He played a little bit of point forward in his time for the Blues. Here's Wilson. He's up and about in this one. One step left-hand layup is just off the mark.
It's a nice take.
Harm splits the defense and tries a Wilson-like pass, and we'll have a held ball. Some good defensive hustle there from Wilson.
Interesting look by Andrew Harms on that pass.
I tell you what, both teams have been given the green light to attack hard against pressing defense, or whether it's in transition, and the fans have been better off for it so far. Harms running the show for Dandenong. They're looking to go to double ball screen. Inside, what a feed from Harms to Long. Outstanding execution.
Armsy with the finger up, just letting the stats bench know that he made the assist pass.
Some slick movement there from the Blues, but Montreal disrupts it. As Maynard and Walker both come back into the ball game, Montreal gets a well-earned rest to think about his missed dunk.
Big 2 minutes right here for both teams. Chance for the Blues to extend the lead or for the Rangers to cut back into it and take one themselves. I'd love to see Ben Lewis get into some action here.
Shot clock at 12, Maynard going one-on-one. Now he feeds to Switala against Walker on two fouls.
Strong move. There you go, big fella.
That's a man-sized move against a man-sized defender, and great finish from Dane Switala. See that double high screen action again. They're looking for long, ducking to the basket on Jack Wilson.
Good recognition by Oswald. Didn't close out hard on Walker. They're happy for him to take that shot, especially just with a hand up, and chance for the Blues to get up a little further here. Big possession again. Maynard getting into the key.
Oswald going at Walker. The Blues making a point of that, but that pass was astray and Odigi's away. Takes it. What a Euro step from Odigi. Walker upstairs, but he can't put it in. And now Lewis is in the open court. Long gets a hand in. And
Chuck's still got those quick hands for the KG veteran.
And here's an opportunity to take your breath. We've got a timeout with 108 to play in the second quarter. We've had 91 points in just 19 minutes of basketball, and it's Frankston leading 48-43. Tom Wilson with 14 points. Josh Oswald with 11 to go with three boards. And Dane Switala, 8 points, four rebounds, and an assist for good measure. Corey Maynard with three assists and two steals. And at the other side of the ledger, Daquan Montreal, 18 points. He's also had a couple of rebounds and two assists. Lucas Walker, 7 points so far. And Gibkiss with six, Harms four, Owies two. And Harms is leading the way with four boards and three assists for Dandenong. What are they talking about here, Steve?
Well, probably just working out who they're going to go through. Each team probably going to get a couple of possessions each year, so probably important that no one picks up a third foul. Interesting that Lucas Walker's staying in for the last minute. Potentially after this offensive possession, they might sub him out. But I'd like to see him go back down low with Switala into that low block. And I think Walker or the young fella, Mason Peatling, is going to have to guard him. So I'm not sure if Mason's a good young talent. I'm not sure if he's got the strength to throw it in low. So let's see if he can throw it inside to Switala here. As
Peatling and Switala having a little chat off the ball. Dane might be saying, you can't guard me. Some good pressing defense right up to the near half court from Harms. Lewis finds Maynard with two on the shot clock. He splashes it down and he finally finds his way to the inside of the Frankston rims, and Frankston lead it by eight. 40 seconds to play. Walker at the top. Alley-oop to Odigi, but the pass is off the mark. A chance perhaps for a 2-for-1 here for Frankston. Lewis exploring. What a crossover!
Big dunk with the killer crossover. Lewis. Well, big possession.
They won't quite get the 2-for-1,
but they'll take
move.
That one.
He split the defense and he soared through the skies for a two-handed jam.
Oh, his dad watching the game live back in Ohio, in St. Louis, will be happy with that one. Oh, beautiful move.
Flew like St. Louis just then. It's a 10-point lead for Frankston. 9.2 seconds left for Dandenong to try and cut into that margin before halftime. And Harms has the responsibility to do it. He pulls up for three. It's off. And Switala pulls in the board. And what a first half from the Frankston Blues. After the first 3 or 4 minutes, it looked like they could be in for a long night. But the Blues responded to Dandenong's intensity. It was Tom Wilson who swung the game with some unconscious three-point shooting. He hit three in a row in the first quarter. And the Blues took a 30-23 lead into quarter time. They've extended that margin to 10 here at halftime. And Steve Blackley, Blues legend, you must be smiling right now.
It was a fantastic start. The the Blues really needed it. It was a tough weekend last weekend, dropping both games and personnel change and having to send someone back home to the States wasn't an easy week on the club and the players, but boy, have they responded well. And definitely just a different look now on the Blues, not only on the offensive end, but on the defensive end. They're playing with a lot more tenacity defensively, and I just love the ball movement. Everyone's getting shots, everyone's contributing, and big adjustment for the team to bring in someone so late, but it doesn't seem like they've missed a beat.
Well, they look so much more organised than they did in their first couple of games, and you've got to put that down to just having an experienced point guard like Corey Maynard. You know, 4 years at Bryant in the college system, a couple of years in the NBL, and this season with Townsville, he really showed he can be an NBL contributor.
Well, he's stuffing the stat sheet with 5 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists, 2 steals. You know, probably hasn't looked for his shot too much, knocked down the 1-3, but getting the ball into the right people's hands and really making an impact and controlling the tempo and being able to put Tommy to that 2-guard and really letting him go out there and score has been huge for the Blues. We thought by making the change that Swatella's going to get more touches and Oswald's going to get more touches, which has happened as well. He's been off to a great start as well, Josh. So
yeah, 11 points and 3 boards for Josh already.
And it's probably something that we're a little conscious of, that Oswald last week got off to a great start against Geelong, had 8 and 8 at halftime, but only had 2 or 3 attempts in the second half. But tonight, you know, 8 attempts already and was aggressive from the start. So, yeah, really, really positive sign. Just a great atmosphere, great night for basketball tonight. Just some 3 or 4 dunks, some fantastic 3-point shooting. It's really all been happening. So
it's been high-octane basketball here at the Frankston Basketball Stadium. The leaders for Dandenong quickly, Daquan Montreal with 18 points. He was on fire early. Lucas Walker with 7. Liam Gimkus with 6. Andrew Harms with 4 boards and 3 assists as well to lead them in those categories. Well, take a breath, folks. We'll be back in about 10 minutes for the second half.
God, that's the trouble with me. I need the trouble with you. I need the trouble to trust.
Yeah, jump man, and boys up to something. They They just spent like 2 or 3 weeks out the country. Them boys up to something, they just not just bluffing. You don't have to call, I hit my dance like Usher. Ooh. I just found my tempo like on DJ Mustard. Ooh. I hit that Ginobili with my left hand up like woo. Lobster and saline for all my babies that I miss. Chicken finger, french fry for them, they don't wanna dance. Jumpin', 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 them boys up to something. I think I need some Robitussin. Way too many questions, you must think I trust you. You searching for answers, I do not know nothing. Woo! I see him tweaking, ain't no something's coming. Woo! Jumpin', 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 them boys up to something. Woo! Jumpin', 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 fam, what you expecting? Woo! Shout out Michael Jordan, just said text me. Woo!
Jumpin', 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 jumpin'. I just seen the jet take out, they up to something. Them boys just not bluffing, them boys just not bluffing. Jumpin', 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 them boys up to something. She was trying to join the team, I told her, wait. Chicken wings and fries, we don't go on dates. No boo, no boo, no boo, no boo, no boo, no boo. I just throw the private dinner in the LA. Trappin' is a hobby, that's the way for me. Money coming fast, we never getting straight. I just had to buy another set. Bentley, Spurs, and Phantom, Jordan fade away.
Yeah, jumpin', jumpin', I don't need no introduction. Jumpin', jumpin', Metro boomin' on production, wow. 100 cousins out in Memphis, they so country, wow. Tell her stay the night, valet, yo, call comf now. Jumpin', jumpin', live on TNT, I'm flexin', ooh. Jumpin', jumpin', they gave me my own collection, ooh. Jump when I say jump, girl, can you take direction, ooh. Mutombo with the, you keep getting rejected, ooh.
Heard it came through Magic City on a Monday. Heard they had the club wild, it was star-studded. A bunch of girls going wild when you turn flooded. And I had them like, wow, cup dotted. Dope man, dope man, dope man, dope man, dope man, dope man. Money on the counter, choppers on the floor. I just caught that tempo, DJ Mustard, woo. Way too much codeine and Adderall. We just count those big racks, whoa. I know I'ma get my boy. I count all these racks that they have on me now, I'ma have you like, whoa. Chanel number 9, Chanel number 5, but you got them both.
Jumpin', 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 them boys up to something. They just spent like 2 or 3 weeks out the country. Them boys up to something, they just not just bluffing.
Jumpin', 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 them boys up to something.
Champagne and tequila, ain't no way that I can choose one. I just mix it all in my solution.
Make sure it's no confusion. You got that bomb, poopy, I know just how to defuse it. Say sass, swish it to your head like Medusa. Let me get you high, baby, all the way to Jupiter. It's time for you to choose her. Know you in the mood, I can tell how you move to the music.
You got that good, that's hard to find. You got that, oh yeah, know me, love you long time. I wanna know about all the good things and the bad things
that we could do.
I wanna know about all the good things and the bad things that we could do, baby.
Trust me, heard you the first time. It's nothing personal, I would've done it to anyone. And I blame where I came from, and I blame all my day ones. You know chubs like Draymond, you better hope not saying none. Them boys, they're a handful. Then I hit them with the high line. Chris Breezy with the dance moves, Mo G with the dance moves, Ad Boy with the dance moves, Jimi Hendrix with the solo. Those are strings that you can't pull. Yeah, and I could really dish it out. Come and get it from the source, with all the word of mouth. Go to state, running practice at my house. What am I about? You gon' really feel it now. I'm out here looking for revenge. All summer 16, all summer 16. Playing dirty, not clean. Out front for a season, looking like a damn football team. All repping one thing. Looking for revenge.
Welcome back to the Frankston Basketball Stadium. It's the Anzac Day Clash. If you've missed the first half, you've missed some high quality action. It's the Blues leading 53-43. Frankston shooting 61% from the field, 53% from the three-point line. That's 8 of 15. Dandenong haven't been too shabby themselves, shooting 50% from the field, but just 3 of 12 from long range. The rebounds are tight. It's 16-15 in favour of Frankston. Dandenong with 10 assists to 7. And the turnovers, 8 turnovers to Frankston, 7 to Dandenong. But the high pace this game has been played at, I'm sure neither coach would be too upset by that. Now I'm Paulo Kennedy, I'm your host all season on Blues Basketball Media. I'm joined by Steve Blackley. And Steve, can the second half be as good as the first one?
Let's hope so. A big adjustment here by Darren Perry, putting Owen Ottigy
Hunter Corey Maynard trying to slow his production down, but as we call that another assist. Owen's got that extra length maybe that Harmsey doesn't have, but here's the key to this engine. This Corey Maynard can really get out and get people involved.
Montreal, tough move again. How many times has he just finished around the side of Dane Swatella? I'd say there's a real bit of chemistry already between Oswald and Maynard as we see that one squirt off his knee out of bounds. I think we had two or three assists between those two, and Josh just seems to know exactly when to arrive at the hoop to get that pass.
Yeah, you're playing on the floor with Corey Maynard. You want to have your hands up ready to catch it because you never know when it's going to get to you.
There's Gibkiss. He had 6 points in the first half, and now he's got an assist. As DQ lost Swatella along the baseline and finishes the casual alley-oop.
Complete breakdown there.
Lewis in some ball screen action. My goodness, that is from the car park. And it ends up in the crowd. And just a quieter start. Well, actually, a start reminiscent of their first quarter to this game. Well, let's see if the Blues can kick into action like they did about an hour ago. Off a couple of screens, looking inside for Walker against Oswald.
Offensive foul on Walker. There's his third.
Lucas Walker trying to nail Tom Wilson with that heavy ball screen. I think that might see him on the bench. There was some discussion amongst the scorers at halftime about whether Lucas Walker had one or two. They decided he had two, and so that is his third.
I'd be going at him right now again, trying to pick up a fourth.
He's defending Benny Lewis, and they do just that. Lewis in the post, spinning, fading away over Walker, and it's long. And perhaps needed to be taking that one right at him.
Yeah, maybe turn up and try and go off the dribble.
Gibkiss posting up inside against Oswald. Walker on the drive, fades away and misses. Now how long will Darren Perry stick with Walker on three fouls? Lewis fumbles that one out of bounds, and we talked about how good the first half was. A little bit of a sloppy start here to the third quarter.
Yeah, both teams been a little careless with the ball in this third quarter, but Blues still holding an 8-point lead, so time to buckle down, get some stops, and put some more scoreboard pressure on.
Arms to Montreal.
Good defense by Sotella.
Gibkiss from mid-range, and he nails it.
And they'll live with that one.
He's a little bit in the Paul Rees variety, the way Liam Gibkiss just gets to the right spots and doesn't try to do anything more than what he's capable of. Now Swatella going against Montreal, and he saves it. Good defense from DQ. Walker finds him, back to Walker. Little floaters off the mark. And not the start to this quarter that Lucas Walker would have wanted. And now Wilson in the open floor and draws a foul on Owen Ottigy. One of the Dandenong supporters behind us thinks that was a little soft. And it's in the book now. It's a 6-point lead for Frankston. 7:16 to play in the third.
Two early fouls to the Rangers as well.
In the first half, the Blues look so organised. Now Maynard looking to settle them down. This time he pulls up. That's a tough
three.
That
was in and out too.
He saw that Montreal's hand was down. Now at the other end, it's Montreal inside. Spins to the left, draws the foul. He is a superstar of the SEABL.
Yeah, once he catches it down that low, look out. I might have to take the responsibility of the damage he's doing tonight. I was the one that recruited him to come out to play for Dandenong many years ago, and it's coming back to haunt me now. It was all fun and games while I was at Dandenong, but DQ just a great player and even greater person, so playing a hell of a game tonight.
25 points for DQ, and he is the main reason Dandenong are still in this ball game. They trail it by three.
Rangers definitely picked up their defensive intensity. Nothing easy for the Blues right now.
Maynard dancing around the ball screen. Here's Oswald. Again, that combination. That foul is going to be called on Tom Wilson. Andrew Harms went flying over the end line. Tom says, who me? I couldn't throw someone that far.
He definitely went down hard for a little amount of contact, so Harms, you did a good job there drawing the attention to the officials.
But the flow that was a trademark of Frankston's game in the first half, we haven't seen that yet. You know, give credit to the Rangers D.
Little zone action here by the Blues.
Prodigy outside. Palms wide open. Bang. How many of them has he hit from that spot, Steve?
Yeah, a few too many.
That's a tied ball game, 55 apiece. Oswald going at Odigy in the low post. That's a tough move. Swatala inside. Goes up strong and draws the foul on Harms. Talk about making something out of nothing there for Dane.
Really been impressed with the way Dane's played tonight. Doing a great job on the boards, played great defense. Probably the first time all season he's got to halftime with no fouls. He's only got the one at the moment, so means he can be a little bit more aggressive defensively on DQ, hopefully.
So Swatala with 8 points and seven rebounds so far. If he keeps going after them like that, he's probably going to go well into double figures. And that's what we saw him opening night against Albury Wodonga, where he ate the glass, and he's probably been a little bit down in that area the last couple of games.
Yeah, had 17 in that outing against Albury and was down on the rebounds, and I know it was a big focus for him tonight coming into this game.
It was up and down in the first half. The crowd were into it. There's a bit of tension around the building now. Just waiting to see how this quarter plays out as the Blues go into a 2-2-1.
Yeah, a little press action themselves. And there it comes. It could come up with this. Oh, unlucky play.
Chuck Long. Oh, he tried to save it off Wilson. It missed. And DQ threw it down for his 27th point.
Little unlucky there, Frankston. They probably nearly caused a turnover and some smart play by Chuck.
So 57 apiece. This is settling down into quite a grind here in the third term. Shot clock at 6. Benny Lewis gets open. Isn't sure, but Swatala again. Lewis down the middle. He's fouled by DQ. Nice pass again from Corey Maynard.
Great job by Dane keeping the offensive ball with a little bit of ruck work, hitting it back out to Maynard. So
Corey Maynard will get a rest. I'm sure it won't be a long one. Jake McCauley back into the ball game. He's hit his last 3 three-pointers. Let's see if he can get open again. A little bit of sweat being wiped up in the middle of the free throw.
Frankston Blues looking fantastic in their camouflage uniforms, specially made for the ANZAC Day. The RSL came on board and sponsored the new uniforms, and something we're going to wear every ANZAC Day, and hopefully for some special occasion games during the year as well. Rare miss from the foul line by Lewis. He's been shooting at about 90% this year.
So Lewis with 10 points, makes that 11. That's a one-point margin. Again, the Blues up the floor. Not over-committing here, just making Dandenong make the move through the press as Odigy looked a little shaky.
Mismatch here with McCauley guarding Odigy.
Peatling against Jack Wilson. They went at that in the first half. Oh, nice pass to Long.
Oh, good block!
Dane Swatala on the recovery.
It was a fantastic pass by Harms, but better defense by Swatala. He's going to have to come up with something again.
Oh,
good
foul.
Really
Swatala.
Good foul.
He hit it hard there too, Harms. Looks at the referee, said that hurt. Give me some free throws. That's just the third free throw on Frankston for the quarter. The third foul. Four on Dandenong. Right at the halfway point.
Well, that's where, you know, you can give that foul up when you're not in foul trouble. He hasn't had the luxury of doing that early on in the short season, but tonight being out of foul trouble can... Oh, DQ for three.
Oh, DQ. He'd been a little quiet from long range after his hot start, and but he gets back, and now he's got 30 points.
Yeah, dangerous. Can't take a possession off against DQ. He'll make you pay every time.
And the complexion just changes a little now with two fouls. Might be in the back of his mind as Benny Lewis finds Jack Wilson. What a feed from Benny.
Beautiful pass. That'll give Jack a lot of confidence to get on the board.
The Blues screen execution has just been so much better as Harms drives at McCauley. Not sure where the foul was there, but it will be in the book and Harms will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, smart play. Just had him off balance a little bit and took it strong to the cup.
It's so noticeable at the offensive end of the floor, the way the Blues have been able to read those screening situations, when to roll, you know, when to stick the screen, when to curl. They've looked a lot better in their execution in that area.
Definitely have, and probably the highlight for me so far is just the unselfish play and the movement that we've seen. I think we spoke last week about the ball sticking on one side of the floor, and tonight the ball's gone from one side to the other, getting some post catches as well. So
I think as the game wore on last week, we just wonder where's the next open look going to come from. Whereas it's a very different story here tonight. Let's see if they can maintain that for the last 14 and a half minutes of the game. There's no doubt Dandenong's defensive intensity has gone up in this third quarter as Wilson can't get that one to go. It's the Rangers who lead it by one, so pretty important part of the game here running into three-quarter time. Harms again to the left hand. What a finish from Andrew Harms.
Beautiful play. He's going to really attack Jake McCauley. He's just got that size and strength advantage. So look for Maynard to get back in pretty quickly.
Reaching foul there on Chuck Long.
Bad foul.
I wonder if Frankston will make that switch and get McCauley guarding Owies in that similar height matchup and put Tom Wilson on Harms. In fact, I think
that might have been the
Wallace
signal right then.
Just give the signal number six, which is Matt Owies.
Yep. They've made the switch already.
So Benny Lewis to the free throw line. There's no mistake on that one as he moves to 12. He hasn't had a lot of shots so far, Benny. Is he someone you'd start running some pin downs for?
I think so. Trying to get him involved and get him into an offensive rhythm would be real helpful. This would be a good matchup as well. Owies and McCauley, a couple of speedsters.
Absolutely. Here's Harms against Wilson. A couple of classy players. Montreal against Oswald.
Oh, Jake's got to stay down on that. Bad defense.
Fell for
They're really going at McCauley.
That's been noticeable about Dandenong. They have picked a defender and gone at them hard as we see a flop there from DQ.
Oh.
He was clipped on the side by Benny Lewis. And again, we get the Australian charge call. And it'll be Dandenong ball. As we see the Wilson brothers to the bench, Maynard back in. And Grant Wallace really showing some faith in Jake McCauley. A couple of mistakes there, but having faith that he'll turn that around.
Well, I think it's a chance to play him while they've gone a little smaller with Owies, so.
Oh, nice feed from Walker to Peatling. Beautiful pass from Lucas.
Yeah, but that Ranger offense is clicking on all cylinders this quarter.
I wonder how long till the Blues go back to a little bit of that full-court pressure, which was disrupting Dandenong and not allowing them to have such precision in the half-court. There's Maynard taking it upon himself, and he's thrown it out of bounds. And just the last couple of minutes, Frankston starting to get a bit bogged down offensively.
Yeah, the ball's getting not getting swung as much, a lot more stuff off the dribble, but credit to the Rangers, they've really picked up their defense.
Harms
getting into the seams again.
Finds Owies for three. It doesn't quite drop. Lucas Walker once, twice. Lucas Walker puts it in. He gives the Rangers a 7-point lead, and Grant Wallace says, I've seen enough. Let's have a timeout.
Yeah, I think time to get McCauley out now. They're really, really going at him. And a bit of a, probably the first time since the first few minutes of the game where the Blues are really under the pump. Scoring slowed down for them this quarter and not in any kind of offensive rhythm at the moment.
It's a 9-2 run in the last 90 seconds of play. And this could be pivotal when we look back at the end of the game. You'd think in these last 2:33 before three-quarter time, Frankston needs to just close this gap a little.
Yeah, really big possession. A big couple of minutes right here. You know, if the Rangers can lock in and extend it out to double figures, it's going to be a hard thing to come back against such an experienced team. But the Blues need to lock in defensively again and then maybe get out and work on their transition game and try and get some easy baskets. Nothing's been easy for them this quarter. Everything's been contested and they had to work hard for their points. So I think it'll all start with their defense.
It's a 26-9 quarter for Dandenong. They've been very impressive here. As you said, though, for the Blues, they look their best in transition, and to get in transition, you've got to play defense.
No, absolutely. So,
and some offensive rebounding coming into it as well.
Yep, McInnes in for McCauley, so they got a little bit more size. So,
this is a good defensive lineup. A lot of guys who can switch, but they've got to get on the boards as well. Here's Maynard against Owies. Looking for Benny Lewis at the top. It's covered by Peatling. Peatling reaches that time. Lewis to the pull-up. What a move from Benny Lewis.
There we go. Benny off the dribble. I like that.
I think he's got to be a crucial part of these final 12 minutes for Frankston, especially with his ability just to jump over the defenders like that. Montreal inside to Peatling. Good help from McInnes. Oh, he scrambles. Lewis.
Good job, Lewis.
Yeah, he knocks it out of bounds with 8 on the shot clock. Now that's some better defensive effort there from the Blues.
I think the matchups are a little better here.
Palms over the head pass. Quick release shot from Montreal as well.
Big rebound, Spatella.
Spatella pulls it in. Somehow finds Benny Lewis. He decides to slow it down. Maynard wide open. Transition three from Corey is off. Here's Benny. Good closeout from Owies. Benny, that's a tough fading three-pointer, and he misses.
Yeah, not a great look on the reset. We had plenty of time on that one. Probably need to swing that over and get it through some hands.
Corey Maynard providing some problems there for Owies. Shot clock ticks to 10. Walker on the alley. Misses. Swatella with yet another rebound. That's number 9 for him, and Maynard is away. Finds Oswald. Spins inside. Blocked by Peatling. Oswald again inside. Doesn't go. That's tipped out by Lucas Walker. And the Blues will get another chance. As you said a minute ago, it's hard work at the moment for Frankston, isn't it?
They've really, the Rangers are playing there. Real tough defense, which is what they're known for. But the Blues are hanging in there since that last time out, but got it back to 5 with a chance to get it back to 2 or 3 here. So big 57 seconds coming up.
I wonder if we'll see a quick hitter here so that perhaps they can get 3 possessions in the final minute.
Oh, a little bit of a mismatch here. Maybe Benny can get Mason off the dribble.
There's Maynard, shot clock at 6. Oh, nice move from Corey.
Beautiful. With the right hand. And smart move. He attacked the body of DQ.
Maynard up to 7 points. He has 4 assists to go with that.
Oh, offensive foul.
Offensive foul. Big screen there from DQ, but he's penalised for it.
Maynard let him know he wasn't happy with it too. So not afraid to back down to anyone, Corey. No. He had a run-in last year in the NBL with Nathan Jawai. They don't come any bigger and meaner and tougher than Jawai. So,
of course, he played his college basketball for the Bulldogs.
Yep.
he fits that moniker well. So 31 seconds to go. Probably a little too late for a 2-for-1. So Dandenong will get another chance. But Frankston can tie the game up on this possession just when it looked like the game was fading out of their reach a little earlier. So Maynard at the top with Swatella.
Oh, good look.
Dane at the free throw line. He pops it. It's in. It's out. And Walker
gonna knock that one down. That was a great look.
So big defensive possession for the Blues and for the Rangers. A chance to show their outstanding execution again. Oh, Swatella sticks with Harms, who retreats to the three-point line and goes again. Feeds DQ.
Good hands,
Benny.
Benny Lewis.
And that'll be three-quarter time, folks. Well, this is set up to be yet another Anzac Day blockbuster. Last year, it was Dandenong who won at 66-61 after full time. It's been a bit more of a shootout this year. And at three-quarter time, Dandenong lead at 69-66. Steve, what's in store for this last quarter?
Well, I think more of the same. Both teams, or neither team, have taken a backward step. The Blues looked like they're up on the ropes a little bit in that quarter, getting down by as many as 8 points, but fought back since that last time out and finished the back to the starters. No one's in serious foul trouble. I think, you know, we're in for a cracking last quarter. The ball looks, the Blues look a lot better when that ball moves. Probably went a little bit too much off the dribble that quarter, and we've got to find a way to shut down DQ.
The Blues took a couple of quick hitting shots. Yeah, a couple of trailing three-pointers. Do you want to see him keep taking that shot, or do you want him to get the ball through hands and get on the rim?
I think depending on who it is, I think Tommy or Benny, that trailing three can be a bit of a weapon. But everyone else, I think, probably put some heat on the ring and probably not bail the defense out with that early shot. I think Benny forced one on an offensive rebound that he probably wishes he could take back. But good fight back from the Blues. The Rangers showing their experience with a fantastic quarter themselves. So we're in for a cracking last quarter, and the big crowd are, no one's left the gym yet. So we're in for a, who knows what's going to happen. Maybe we might get to overtime. We're not going anywhere just yet.
Tom Wilson, scoreless that quarter. He had 14 at the half. What are the Blues got to do to get him back involved?
I think probably some transition stuff for Tommy as well, and I think he'll probably play 6 or 7 minutes of this last quarter. Not sure if he'll start. They haven't come out of their huddle yet, but potentially he'll sit for the first couple and then come in and finish the quarter off strong. But the good thing for the Blues that quarter is they did rest some players. Everyone got some rest on the bench, so the boys should be fresh. And yep, the Rangers gone back to their starting lineup. The Blues have got four of their five starters out with on the court, with Tommy having a quick rest and Mike McKinnis sitting starting the last quarter. Maybe Mike's the spark we need with a couple of big bombs.
It could be. And in terms of Dandenong, Montreal has put on a clinic, 30 points tonight. What do you got to do to stop him? Is there something you can take away? Is there something you give him?
Yeah, you just can't give him that. Beautiful drive by Walker. Just can't give him that uncontested three. Everything's got to be contested. He's good enough that he'll make some of them, but we probably gave him a couple too many open looks, and mate, he'll make you pay every time.
11 points now for Lucas Walker. Extends the margin to 5. Look at the Rangers switching defense. Maynard goes himself. That's a tough shot for Josh. Dane Swatella on the boards. He's been outstanding. 11
good job,
rebounds.
Maynard. Spatella keeping it alive.
Now they'll go inside to him.
Tack.
Against Gibkus. That's a nice move from Spatella. He just left a little long. Lucas Walker pulls in board number 5.
I'd like to get him on the ring on that move. Really get into that charge circle and make the referees make a call.
Dandenong are really packing the paint down there. You just feel someone for Frankston's going to have to hit a couple of threes to draw them out. Here's Odigy. Had a bright start to
Harms
the game.
From the car park.
Oh my goodness, Andrew Harms
all the way from Cannanook Station.
Now that is a big shot after all the hard work the Blues did late in the third quarter to bring it back. It's now an 8-point game. Lewis, there's that tough pull-up shot, but hand in there from Montreal.
Oh, Oswald with the steal.
Maynard spinning. Walker's still at him.
Oh, there's
Lucas
a fourth foul. That was
foul.
A careless one.
Yeah, that's been one of the trademarks of Lucas Walker's career. Some careless action like that. Let's see what Darren Perry does.
Lucas was telling DP that he's okay, but he's leaving him out there, so putting some faith in the players.
8-point ball game. Just over 8 minutes to play.
That's what I want to see, Dane. Take it to the basket, but big stop.
Alley-oop coming here. Oh, bounce pass, and Lewis read it. Now a chance, 3-on-2 for the Blues. Lewis to Maynard, big shot for Corey Maynard. Corey Maynard up to 10 points, and it's back to 5.
Great defensive play by Benny Lewis, and then found the open Maynard on the wing.
A little bit of energy in the gym now. Montreal with a little shuffle.
Good
steps
defense.
Back, and rims out. Maynard with another board.
Really good defense by Sotella. Make it a contested shot, which I spoke about at the three-quarter time break.
Now, Sotella's defense on Montreal hasn't been bad tonight. Just hasn't quite been at the level required to stop DQ. Here's Mike. McKinnis on the drive to the right hand. Tough shot. Sotella in, but he
can't.
Not
sure that's the shot we want from Mike.
Walker on the drive. Little floater is short. Sotella's in there. And that's going to be a Dandenong ball.
And Mike's got to be a little smarter on that one. Get into the basket. If you can't get all the way, pull it out. And we've got plenty of time on the shot clock. Look for Tommy Wilson to get in pretty soon, I think, for Mike. Oh, DQ, the three was open there for a minute.
Now Harms will go ball screen with him. Takes it at Maynard.
Good hands by Benny Lewis.
It's in, it's out. Gibkus up. Swatella meets him. And McInnes pulls in the board.
Good job, Mike McInnes. Getting on the off defensive boards.
What about the defense from Dane Swatella? He just held his ground and made that a tough shot for Gibkus.
And even the defensive rebound, he didn't grab the rebound, but kept it alive and with a little tip, and he's done a great job doing that. Dane's taking a spell, I think, working his tail off to look for him for a minute or so just to get a breather and get back in. And hopefully Tommy gets back into that game pretty soon as well.
This is such an important period. Gibkus, Walker and Montreal all in the game for Dandenong, but for Frankston, undersized with Lewis, Jack Wilson and Oswald as the front court as Benny elevates and Benny connects. Shot. Benny Lewis up to 17 points. He is just starting to come into the game. It's a three-point difference again. This is building up to be some sort of finish. They look to go inside to Walker.
Yeah, look for the deep seal for Daquan here.
Gibkus inside, but he's well covered by Lewis. Harms is going to fire.
Again.
Six on the clock, and he nails it. Andrew Harms with yet another homecoming to remember.
Yeah, just reminding the Frankston faithful what a great player he was here at the Blues.
16 points for Harmsy. McInnes into the lane.
Oh, nearly went out of bounds on that one.
Reset, 10 on the shot clock. Corey Maynard to McInnes. That's
Give
his shot,
the mic.
It's off. And Gibkus with the big board. So Dandenong with a chance to repel yet another
Daquan's
charge.
Daquan's got the mismatch here.
Walker against McInnes. Daquan inside and a hard foul from Mike McInnes. As Tom Wilson comes to check in for the Blues, Chuck Long coming in to replace Lucas Walker for the Rangers.
I think Tommy may have sat a couple extra minutes. I think Coach Wallace was trying to get him in, but was waiting for a whistle. So look for Swatella to come back in the next minute or so for Jack Wilson as well, so they can finish with their starting group.
DQ makes the first. Not a big night on the boards for DQ. He's only got three. Harms leading the way with eight for Dandenong. He's also got four assists and 16 points. He has just steadily built a quality night.
Daquan, not a huge rebounder. He's kind of good for 6 to 8, but he's good for 30-odd points every game.
So it's an 8-point ball game. The yo-yo continues. Dandenong, bring it out. Frankston, bring it back, but they can't quite put their noses in front. Maynard with 7 on the clock. Spins and throws it out of bounds. And his passing's just been a little bit off the mark in the second half.
Yep. And the look was there. It was just a half a second too late.
Dandenong with a little bit of bounce in their step. They've got a mismatch inside. Gibkus against Oswald, and Oswald strips it. Chuck Long inside. Big hustle play from the veteran.
We're starting to see a little bit what happened to the Blues against Geelong down the stretch. These teams that have been playing together for quite a while just seem to execute that a little bit better.
Another ambitious pass, this time from Tom Wilson. And Owen Ottergy a little unlucky on that call. He tipped it to Harms. The ref said he did so illegally. So 4:55 to run. Dane Swatella remains on the bench. In fact, here he comes. He'll take Jack Wilson out of the ball game. That's now or never for Frankston.
Yep, good sub. Back to the starters. I think you'll see Coach Wallace go with this lineup. Unless we see some foul trouble or something. McCauley coming in for Maynard, maybe for a minute, just to give him a quick breather. Hasn't quite got his game legs under him just yet, because he was having some time off basketball. So
that's good recognition from Grant Wallace. He saw a couple of uncharacteristic errors there from Corey. That's the sure sign of fatigue. So Walker back in, Matt Owies back in. Owen Ottergy takes a seat on the bench. as does Liam Gibkiss. 10-point ball game. Wilson exploring. McCauley closed down quickly by Harms.
I think we're going to need some magic from Tommy.
Steps back into that three. It's short. Harms with yet another rebound. Number 9 for him. The Blues just struggling to find a good look. Alley-oop to Harms. Oh, Montreal is fouled.
And again, they're going straight to that mismatch with McCauley. Every single time he's on the floor, they're looking to get inside against him.
Got the ball stuck up against the rim there. None of the players willing to volunteer. Chuck says, I can do that. He rips it down.
I'm pretty sure referee Dean wasn't going to get up there and grab it off the ring.
So do the Blues need to change something up defensively here? Do we need to see a bit of trapping zone?
Potentially get up
like
the
that?
Floor and, you know, potentially been 12 down after these two free throws. They're going to need to change the tempo of the game a little bit.
I think
maybe getting the offense through Benny Lewis as well.
And the other big area is that defensive rebounding. We're seeing Long, Montreal, Walker really attacking the offensive glass hard. And it makes it so hard for Frankston to transition out and get some easy looks. Some big moments here for the Blues. Lewis guarded by Chuck Long on the baseline. Can't get free. And you talk about a team not familiar with each other. Cheap turnover. Oh, he's to the basket and he finishes. And it's starting to look grim for the Blues as Chuck Long. A professional foul to stop the fast break. With 4:02 left to play, the Blues have a 14-point hole to dig themselves out of.
The turnover's been huge for the Blues this quarter.
They're now up to 15 turnovers for the game to just 10 assists. You talk about the field goals, they're above 60% at halftime. They're down to 46% as Dandenong have put the clamps on. McCauley spinning in, looking for Satuala. Nice move, but it rims out. Oswald with the board. Here's Lewis. He's hit on the head. He can't get it to go. But a much better offensive set that time. Got Dane inside, got an offensive rebound. And
smart,
then a quick
smart recognition by Jake on that one. Not pulling the trigger and getting it into the hands of Lewis.
Are they at the point now where they need to start quick shooting the basketball, or is it still a time to run some offense and get good looks?
Well, I think they've got to pull the trigger if they're open in transition, and Maynard, Wilson, Lewis, if they're open early, pull the trigger. And I mean, 14 down, they've got nothing to lose at this stage. Again, Lewis misses from the free throw. He only missed a couple for the entire season. He's missed two tonight.
3 of 5. He's got 17 points and 4 assists, shooting 42%. So it's been a solid night for Benny. But at 13 points down, I think they're going to need a little bit of something special from Benny.
Yep.
Perhaps Tom Wilson to rediscover that early game form as well, as Montreal pushes Swatella away, but can't make the three-pointer. The Blues breathe again. Here comes Lewis. Yeah. A little bit
another
ambitious
turnover
that time. And Swatella fouls.
Turnover is just
fourth.
Killing the Blues at the moment.
We talked in the first half about how much more organized the Blues look than in previous weeks, but as the pressure's gone up from Dandenong, that has fallen away, and perhaps it will take a little bit of time with Maynard in the lineup to get that four-quarter execution.
I think you're right, a little bit of time together, but yeah, you can just see the complete opposite with the Rangers. Coach Darren Perry's been away for the last two games and only got back this morning from the under-18 Nationals, and they don't look like they've missed a beat. A lot of the core players here have played together for several years, and we spoke about that last week against Geelong. The Blues were able to stick with them for the majority of the game, but down the stretch, Geelong were just too clinical with their execution at both ends of the floor, and probably something that the Blues are striving to get to.
So it's a Dandenong timeout. Darren Perry drawing up a play. And you'd imagine with not that many possessions left, probably Frankston can only allow Dandenong to score probably two or three more times for the game.
Yeah, I think if they get above 90, then pretty miraculous to get back into it.
So it's Daquan Montreal with 34 points, Andrew Harms with 16, who have led the way for Dandenong. For Frankston, Benny Lewis the best with 18 points. And they've had five players in double figures. Tom Wilson with 14, but he hasn't scored in the second half.
I think the Blues have had a good contribution from a lot of players, but no one that's taken over the game like a Daquan Montreal.
What a pass there from DQ. An overplay from Maynard, and Andrew Harms makes him pay. He's got 18 points now for the game. And the Rangers putting on a show, showing why it's a little surprising that they're at 1-3. They did have some injury concerns. They look like they put them behind them tonight. Here's Odigy to the basket. He's blocked by Benny Lewis. Lewis will go again.
Smart play by Odigy,
pulling
it out.
It out.
Just taking some time off the clock.
Benny looked primed to fly in there again and have another swat. Just 2:24 to run. Six on the shot clock. Harms to end it with a three. He can't. Might as well will pull in the board. That's number six for him to go with 13 points. Maynard to Wilson. Takes it strong at Walker and can't finish it.
Just can't buy a basket in this last quarter. It's a pretty good take by Tommy, but
Corey Maynard all over Owies. And we tick under 2 minutes. This will be a Dandenong victory.
Oh, there's another alley-oop.
Alley-oop to Walker. What a feed from Andrew Harms, who puts his hand up again. He's got 9 rebounds, 5 assists, 18 points, and Corey Maynard with a tough finish inside.
The air's been taken out of this gym now. They're probably just playing out time, being 15 down with a minute 44 to go, but
Blue's still up the court. They haven't given it up yet. Oh, he's against Maynard. Corey all over him. Wilson steps up to help. Harms down the middle, stripped by Benny Lewis, and that'll be a Blues ball. The long arms of Benny Lewis.
He's poked a few steals away tonight.
Two steals, two blocks, four assists, 18 points. Perhaps just the 7 turnovers, the only blotch on his copybook. Nice feed. Here is Lewis underneath. He elevates. Can't get it to go. Swatella.
Just can't make a basket down the stretch.
It's almost like the Blues have just run out of legs in this final turn. Missing shots they'd normally make. Dandenong on the other hand. They look fresh. Walker for three. This would ice it. Bang. Lucas Walker. Makes it an 18-point game. He's got 16 to go with 6 boards after some early foul trouble. Maynard with a three. It's off. Swatella will just bank that one in. It's been a good night for Dane. He's got 12 points to go with 12 boards.
A good double-double for Dane, getting back in after a couple of quiet games last weekend.
A little double team there, the ball knocked away. Referee deemed that was a foul. And that's the 4th on Frankston. So both teams now in the bonus.
No need to foul now, the game's out of reach.
38 seconds left. Harms against Maynard. It was Corey in the first half who looked good, but Andrew Harms has made his mark in the when it mattered. Lewis and Oswald. Lewis will go himself and finger roll it in. 20 points for Benny Lewis. So when we look at this game, it's similar to the matchup with Geelong, similar to the match against Kilsyth. Veteran teams that know each other well. Three quarters of good basketball for Frankston, not able to sustain it. What's the next step for the Blues?
Well, I think it's just sticking tight together. They've got a really tough weekend next weekend down in Tasmania. It doesn't get any tougher than playing down there, and I think this group just needs more time to basically play together. For me, that's the big thing that stands out. that against these experienced groups, we can kind of hang with them for quite a while, but just can't put it away. And it's a lot of just little execution and defensive breakdowns when things get really, really tight that kind of become real costly at the end. But I think, you know, we showed that we're heading in the right direction with Maynard stepping in for Ishmael. I think we're in the right direction that way, and you know, I think they stuck together. There was no bad signs of guys turning on each other and getting down on each other. So you know, it is a process for us rebuilding this club, and I think tonight was, although they went down by 14, probably a step in the right direction as far as sticking together and hanging with one of the elite teams in the competition.
So the final score, Dandenong 92, Frankston 78. It was Daquan Montreal who really set up the victory with his 34 points. And when he went a little quieter, there were others to step up. Harms finished with 18, Walker with 16. It was a solid finish. Benny Lewis led the way for Frankston with 20 points. Tom Wilson had 14, and Josh Oswald with 13 to go with his 6 boards. Of course, Dane Swatella with his 13 boards. Did you like the balance of the team? It's a little different. You brought in a guard for a forward. What did you think of the balance out there tonight for the Blues?
I think that definitely worked for us. The chemistry was a lot better than maybe what it's been in the past as well. And I think probably more in the first half than the second half, the ball swung a lot more and got through hands, and probably everyone got their shot attempts that they needed. I think in the end, turnovers were really costly, and the fact that they had a superstar in Daquan Montreal taking over the game. And I think Andrew Harms really stepped up in that last quarter and, you know, we had 18 points or something, 9 rebounds, 5 assists. Was just that floor general and
yep.
Was able to set the table for everybody else tonight.
He certainly did. In the final quarter, they ate a tasty meal. Early in the game, though, the pressure defense from the Blues, were you happy with what they produced there?
Yeah, I think for 3 quarters, they really did. They hung in there, and Coach Wallace would have taken some real positives out of it. But, yeah, just being able to sustain that for 40 minutes, and they're getting to that 30-minute mark, but just not being able to finish off the job. So good to see Josh Oswald bounce back and have a good game. Swatella bounced back and finished with a double-double, so that was positive. Tommy, who's been a little down on some form as well, again, had a good game. So I don't think anyone played bad for the Blues, just at the Rangers with that little bit better and just a little bit too much polish.
They looked very versatile tonight, Dandenong. What's the message they're sending to the rest of the competition?
Well, I think Walker's only been in for a couple of games now. DP's been away for a couple of weeks with state commitments. So, mate, they'll be a top two, top three team again and give it a crack. Whenever you've got a reigning MVP in Daquan Montreal and guys of the calibre of Harms and Walker, throw in Odigy and some of Australia's best young talent, they're always going to be in the mix. So that's the great thing about the SEABL. It's a great competition. It's the elite competition during the winter break, and there are no games off.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the broadcast. It was a stunning first half of basketball. The third quarter was tough, tense and tight. The final quarter was all Dandenong, but some promising signs for the Frankston Blues. So join us again on Blues Basketball Media. We're bringing you every home game of the season. I'm Paulo Kennedy. On behalf of Steve Blackley, have a good night.